नमस्ते आला।
यू नो गड़बड़ हो गई। गड़बड़ यूं हुई कि आई हैड आस्क्ड यू के प्ले फॉर कपल ऑफ मिनट्स देन से यू नो लाइक विद अ फिल्मी स्टाइल लाइक अ वेरी ड्रामेटिक स्टाइल लुक एट द कैमरा देन से दिस इज अलार्म सो स्टार्ट प्लेइंग वी आर लाइव एनीवे सो स्टार्ट प्लेइंग आफ्टर टू मिनट्स देन यू लुक एट द कैमरा लाइक वेरी मेडिटेटिव स्टेट एंड देन लुक एट द कैमरा एंड वेरी रोमांटिकली से दिस इज अलार्म in rag da 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 like that I am shutting myself off 3, 2, 1 you are there on the screen now
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Oh. Thank you.
Sorry, we have a situation with the light around here today.
Hi, namaskar.
Hi.
तुम्हारी तरफ से मुझे नमस्कार, मेरी तरफ से मेरे को नमस्कार. How are you? This is looking. This is a brilliant. I think the best set that I have yet hosted in the Baithak series.
Thanks to Mada.
Yeah. Or but why did you stop? I thought that you were going to play the bandish also after this.
No, I decided not to play the bandish.
I mean, you decide on your own. This is amazing.
This is
unfair.
I will
this is totally unfair. You cannot decide like that. You know, प्यार का वादा 50-50 होता है, आधा आधा होता है. You cannot literally.
वो सब हम decide करते हैं, ये सब लिखा हुआ होता है.
कौन लिखता है?
लिखता कौन है?
लिखवाता है. Let's switch this thing off.
Yeah, yeah. So, welcome to the 129th Yarnath Virtual Bedeck series, Jokes Apart. Well, friends, today is a it's my pleasure actually to be in conversation with one of the world's finest Veena exponents and Dhrupad maestros, the son of the legendary Ustad Zia Mohiuddin Dagar, the nephew of the legendary Ustad Zia Fariduddin Dagar. Of course, you all know him, but those of you who are seeing him for the first time, many friends from Europe and North America and other parts of the world, Mohi Bahuddin is born into a family of Dhrupad musicians that has adhered to the Dagurbani, which is one of the four styles of singing and playing, of course, not just singing, but Indian music. The oldest being Khandarvani, now Harivani, Gavarharivani, and Dagurvani, the four, and they are the students and, of course, bearers of the Dagurvani. But of course, it is also important to understand that in the old times, everybody played everything. For example, his grandfather, one of the greatest legends, Ustad Ziauddin Khan, used to play more of Khandarvani. It was very, very robust, very extraordinary style. I mean, so much so that Ustad Bade Ghulam Ali Khan was wow, like Lattu, when he was so amazed that he became, he said to become his disciple. Is that right? Am I remembering it right?
Yeah.
And it was in Lahore. It was in Lahore. It was in Lahore, actually.
Where Ziauddin Khan Saab's.
It was in Lahore.
Yeah, Lahore, sorry.
Yeah.
He sang Puriya. Yeah, he sang
exactly.
Puriya. And the thing about Puriya is you can stand on the ray, but he was standing on the ray.
Array, you cannot. No. This is. I'm introducing you. You cannot steal my time now. You decide not to play the bandish, but you cannot run away. You know that I'm the dacoit in chief. You cannot mess with me. So you tell me about the Puriya. We'll come to the Puriya composition because I'll rather hear in detail. So let me just finish your introduction. He, of course, Mohi Bahuddin began his foray into Indian classical music training on the sitar under the tutelage of his Vidwan mother, Srimati Pramila Dagar. He was introduced to the Rudraveena by his father, of course, Ustad Zia Mohiuddin of the Dagurbani, one of the finest Rudraveena maestros and an innovator. He did innovations, and we'll talk about that later. And of course, his uncle Ustad Zia Fariduddin, as I mentioned earlier, an Indian classical vocalist, but who also played the sitar, in fact. And from whom he, you know, I've seen him grow, and we all grew together in Bhopal and other places where he used to be, you know, under the gaze of his uncle. He received a fellowship from the Ministry of Human Resource Development and has been conferred the Sangeet Natak Academy Award. He has worked on projects with A.R. Rahman. He has restored the sitar, engaged in the restoration of the sitar with the Victorian Albert Museum, designed Rasveena, an improvisation on the Saraswati Veena to make changes in the tonal quality to adapt to Dhrupad. He teaches vocal and instrumental forms of music to students at Dhrupad, established by his father. It's an institution. Along with all performances, along with performances all over the world, he is a cross-platform performer. He has made regular appearances on television and radio networks. He's currently working on reintroducing the Sur Sringar into the Dhrupad genre. And we will talk about this. Dosto, ji aaya nu e 129va mela hega Yarnath Virtual Baithak series da. Aaj main hamwartak hega Dhrupad de Vidwan aur Veena, Rudraveena Vadak, janab Mohi Bahuddin. Inna nu ustad akhar ton allergy hegi hai, par tusi inna nu ustad keh lo ta koi buri gal nahi. Te koi buri gal nahi. ते आप बड़े ही 20वीं शताब्दी दे विद्वान ध्रुपद the Gayak or Rudrabina, the Vadak, Ustad Zia Mohiuddin Hona, the Suputar Hange or Inadi Jari, or Patije Hange, Inadi Chacha Ji San Ustad Zia Fariduddin Khan Jari Dagurwani Parampara, the follow ਕਰਦੇ ਸਨ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿਦਵਾਨ ਉਹਦੇ ਨੁਮਾਇੰਦੇ ਸਨ ਇਸ ਬਾਣੀ ਦੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਨੁਮਾਇੰਦੇ ਹਨਗੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਫੈਲੋਸ਼ਿਪ ਮਿਲੀ ਹੈ ਮਿਨਿਸਟਰੀ ਆਫ ਹਿਊਮਨ ਰਿਸੋਰਸ ਡਿਵੈਲਪਮੈਂਟ ਤੋਂ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਸੰਗੀਤ ਨਾਟਕ ਅਕਾਦਮੀ ਪੁਰਸਕਾਰ ਨਾਲ ਨਵਾਜਿਆ ਜਾ ਚੁੱਕਿਆ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕਈ ਪ੍ਰੋਜੈਕਟਸ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਕੰਮ ਕੀਤਾ ਆ ਏ ਆਰ ਰਹਿਮਾਨ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਵੀ ਫਿਰ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਵਿਕਟੋਰੀਅਨ ਐਲਬਰਟ ਮਿਊਜ਼ੀਅਮ ਅਤੇ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਸਿਤਾਰ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਵੀ ਰਿਸਟੋਰ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੈ ਵਿਕਟੋਰੀਅਨ ਐਲਬਰਟ 'ਚ ਮੈਂ ਵੀ ਜਦੋਂ 95-96 ਗਿਆ ਸਾਂ ਉਦੋਂ ਕਈ ਸਾਜ਼ਾਂ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਮੈਂ ਵੀ ਉਦੋਂ ਕੰਮ ਕੀਤਾ ਸੀ ਕਈ ਗੁਆਚ ਗਏ ਸੀ ਨਾਮ ਵਗੈਰਾ ਉਹ ਮੈਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਦਿੱਤੇ ਸਨ ਸੋ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਬੜੀ ਖੁਸ਼ੀ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਵੀ ਉੱਥੇ ਕੰਮ ਕੀਤਾ ਹੈ ਬਾਕਾਇਦਗੀ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਇੱਕ ਰਸ ਵੀਣਾ ਕਰਕੇ ਇਜਾਦ ਵੀ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੈ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਸਰਸਵਤੀ ਵੀਣਾ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਕੁਛ ਬਦਲਾਅ ਕਰਕੇ ਤਾਂ ਕਿ ਉਹਦੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਟੋਨਲ ਕੁਆਲਿਟੀ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਤੁਰਪਤ 'ਤੇ ਵੱਜ ਸਕੇ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕੁਛ ਉਹਦੇ 'ਚ ਇਨੋਵੇਸ਼ਨਸ ਵੀ ਕੀਤੀਆਂ ਜਿਹਦੇ ਬਾਰੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਜਾਣਕਾਰੀ ਲਵਾਂਗੇ ਆਪ ਤਾਲੀਮ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਗਾਉਣ ਦੀ ਵੀ ਔਰ ਤੰਤੀ ਸਾਜ਼ਾਂ ਦੀ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਫਾਦਰ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਮਰਹੂਮ ਪਿਤਾ ਉਸਤਾਦ ਜ਼ਿਆ ਮੋਹਿਉਦੀਨ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਬਣਾਈ ਹੋਈ ਸੰਸਥਾ ਸੀ ਜਿਹਦਾ ਨਾਂ ਹੀ ਧਰੁਪਦ ਸੀ ਉੱਥੇ ਇਹ ਸੇਵਾਨਸ਼ੀ ਹਨਗੇ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਵੱਡੇ ਗੁਰਭਾਈ ਪੰਡਿਤ ਪੁਸ਼ਪਰਾਜ ਕੋਸ਼ਟੀ ਹੁਣ ਵੀ ਉੱਥੇ ਤਾਲੀਮ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਇਕੱਠੇ ਚਲਾਉਂਦੇ ਨੇ ਪੂਰੀ ਦੁਨੀਆ 'ਚ ਇਹ ਵਾਦਨ ਕਰ ਚੁੱਕੇ ਨੇ ਔਰ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਟੈਲੀਵਿਜ਼ਨ ਔਰ ਰੇਡੀਓ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਤਾਂ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਪਰਫੋਰਮੈਂਸਿਸ ਔਰ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਰਹਿੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਇਸ ਵੇਲੇ ਇਹ ਸੁਰ ਸ਼ਿੰਗਾਰ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸਾਜ਼ ਇੱਕ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਅਲੋਪ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਸੀ ਉਸ ਦੀ ਇਹ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਵਾਪਸ ਉਜਾਗਰ ਕਰ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਸੋ ਵੈਲਕਮ ਅਬ ਬਤਾਓ ਲੈਟਸ ਗੋ ਟੂ ਫਸਟ ਐਨੀਵੇ ਵੈਲਕਮ ਟੂ ਯੂ ਐਂਡ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਸੇ ਹੈਲੋ ਟੂ ਐਵਰੀਬਾਡੀ ਦੈਨ ਵੀ ਸਟਾਰਟ ਆ ਕਨਵਰਸੇਸ਼ਨ Everybody is saying hellos to you. I don't have to repeat some of the elders like Pandit Apne, Professor Ravindra Vasavada from who was the director at the SEPT University, Ahmedabad, conservation architect. He sort of has been an admirer of your father's veena. I was very happy, he told me. And so many other elders have joined in today. Someone who doesn't like you much, Sunanda Sharma, also is joining today. And of course, one of the Vidwan, one of the nations is Vidwans, Pandit Somdat Battu, appreciated. He said, very tuneful playing, especially Meen and Ghaseed work is just amazing. Like that, I mean, many, Manjari Sinha ji is saying what a melodious and meditative opening of the Baithak. But she was referring to me, not to you. I take my, I'm going to steal.
I'm with you, I have no choice.
This is a very nice praise, so why should I let you have it alone? There's someone called Shabana Dagar, I don't know, you know her, you know. She said sukoon pata nahi ye ilzam laga rahi hai ke tareef kar rahi hai
ilzam
laga shawana dekh lo tumhara ilzam lag gaya and pushpraj bhai is also okay I mean so many wonderful friends from around the world are joining in Suchita Rao is here and many others that I know but others I do not know maybe your friends in your circle So I welcome you all. And this is a conversation which Bahauddin tried to avoid for I don't know what 6 months or a year. You always run away from conversing with me, isn't it?
Yeah, you're a dangerous man.
How dangerous am I?
Pretty. Sunanda can tell you. You put this googly questions to everybody.
Oh, really? But there are no bouncers that come from me, only googlies, huh? That's an accusation or a praise?
Equally both. Depends on who is batting.
I see. So this is, I mean, this rag that you played, Kamboji, is you know, is said to be related to the Kamboji, the Kambo tribe, the Kambo.
Yeah.
But is it familial connection with the Kambo tribe, or how is it? How is your family? Is there a memory of that?
No, I don't remember a memory of that.
It's not come of that. Okay.
It's just, I think South mein jyada bajate Kambodhi ke naam se. And since my father always mentioned that there is no difference between North and South, the ragas. It's just the way you look at them and how you interpret them. So we have taken rags like Vardhani, Kamboji, Kanakangi, Vagadhishwari, Kange Bhushani.
Right. I see. So that explains that answers my question, in the sense that the raga is not come from the tribe affiliation, but from the south. That explains.
These ragas have been played in the south. I think I don't know how they reach the south. Maybe sea route or something. And generally, as I know, I think different gharanas or different, like they are called the Begaswara Giti. So they would have certain set of rags which the other Gitis would not touch. जैसे जो राग डागरवाणी में बजते हैं वो जयपुर वाले भी नहीं बजाते थे. जो जयपुर में बजते थे अनवट राग वो दूसरे आगरा वाले नहीं गाते थे. तो ये एक उन्होंने अपने had put a boundary amongst themselves. So
interesting.
I will do this. Not that they would not teach them, they would teach them, but उनसे सुन लो, listen to them, this is their raag. So,
but was it, to my memory, it was more about the regard of, if somebody touched a rag in a certain height, others would not sing. It was not that there was a cultural or a gharanidari divide, but it was more about etiquette. Let's say if I am sort of outstanding in singing Shri Rag, for example, then others would say, you know what, Shri sunna hai to bhai Baldeep se sune. But I'm going to play this. So I will also say that, you know what, somebody asked me, sir, why don't you sing Kalyan? I said, no, but I would rather that you and I listen to Kalyan played by Mohi Bahauddin, because I enjoy it there. So to me, the memory, the way it has come, that was also a matter of...
This led to that.
Okay. It was an ittefaq between the Vidwans.
Darbari Kannada ka naam, Darbari Hindustan se was singing it in the Darbar, so he will sing it. Aur unhone jaise Deepak gaya waise dusro din nahi gana chahiye, to it was like a reverence ki inse suniye. Aur waisa probably one was not able to listen to another version of that. So you know,
for example, Darbari ka again, because the original, the oldest form is the Shuddh Kannada, which doesn't exist anymore in the Hindustani, but in the Gurbani tradition, we sing, which is a Kannada of the Kafi male, not of the Asavari male. So
and
what?
Jaipur Atomi sings Shuddh Kannada.
Also, acha.
They have something. Uh-huh. Yeah, they have something.
It's different from the Naiki Kannada?
Sorry?
It's different from the Naiki Kannada, the way they sing?
It's different from the Nike.
Okay. I'd love to hear that, because apart from my tradition, I mean the Gurbani Sangeet Parampara, which was the said to be the oldest and the widest, because 36 authors from across South Asia, the Guru Vani was sung by Kabir, Namdev, Ravidas, Dev Vani was across South Asia. So Shuddh Kannada I've only heard from within the Gurbani Sangeet tradition. But that was the Kafi male, and the Darbari Kannada, the way, for example, just the Darbari kehte, but the Asavari male Kannada, the way we sing, we don't say it, is using both the Nikhads, for example. The Antara ascent goes with the Tivar Nikhad. That is the oldest form that we still have. But that is also, you know, the, I think the Mia Tansens was only the Asavari male, not the... as we all sing, what the Darbari is only with the Asavari male. That's very, very interesting. But I thought that I'll share my thoughts on how... Are you engaging in sign language with me or...?
No, I want to switch off one microphone.
I see. And so it's interesting that Kamboji and others, I was wondering where it comes from. So it's from the South, the interactions with the South that the raga has come in.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, but like you said, it has come from Kamboj, from the north of Afghanistan somewhere.
Right, because I come from Sultanpur Lodi in the Kapurthala area. We have like a lot of Kambo biradari, the whole tribe. It's we've, I mean, villages after villages of the Kambo Sikhs. So they're very fond, they're very proud that, you know, many of the friends from the Kambo brotherhood, they're very, you know, they take pride in saying that we have a rag, that is our tribal raga. I think Gujri and others, there were many ragas which were associated with the, ragas that have been derived from the tribal tunes. Multani is the region. I think it's like Purvi is from Vrindavan, Multani is come from the region of Multan, but Multani is not a tribe. Multan is a area, no, region. So apart from the ragas associated with the regions or rivers, for example, Bibhas comes from river. The Sanskrit name of Bibhasha is a Bias river, one of the sacred rivers of South Asia, one of the five rivers of Punjab. Like that, I think rivers and Saraswati, for example, and their ragas associated with that, these are that. So, what do I ask you first? You know, people accuse you of playing so well.
It is a blessing. I think it's a blessing if you are able to do your work, because I think it takes a lot. It takes a lot in terms of not only just your commitment, but a whole lot of people around you, the environment around you, whole lot of people that you have met throughout your life from a childhood, who have encouraged you, who have helped you out, you know, who want you to become a musician, a good musician, want you to become someone who takes his work seriously. All these people have had numerous influences over your life. And at the same time, there is a lot of love in the way which they want you to do it. They're pouring love into you. So that love kind of mixes with what you have learned. And also, I must say, all the people who hate you have pushed you to do this. So I think this this is a culmination of everything that's happening outside, going inside you and coming out as an observation or as an inspiration. It can be good, it can be bad, and it can be ugly, and it's the way it is.
And the other, typically, you know, us who belong to families which have, you know, been fortunate to have music and arts and culture, it's not just reserved to families which have only had music, any form of music, but also it could be even estates, you know. It could be one accusation or one burdensome tippany, like a stigma, is that we get it easy, and that it comes easy.
It doesn't. Nothing comes easy. It all looks easy. It's like you're eating the cooked food. You ask the person who cooks the food. If you want a particular dish with a particular taste in it, then there's a lot of preparation to go into that. It is not just preparation. It is the entire way you're going to live your life, how your ideas are, how you're going to, you know, think about it. Resolving a whole lot of personal issues in life and correcting your path all the time is one of the big factors that helps you to make it look easy. But inside, when a musician is playing, he's struggling the most, I feel. He's struggling the most because he's trying to make a split second decision on how to put two things together and whether they will gel or not. Only he will only come to know that when it when the two notes strike or they come close to each other or there is a, you know. So जैसे बोलते हैं ना कि सुनने में बड़ा सुकून है, इट्स ओनली इन द लिसनिंग दैट इज ग्रेट पीस. द पर्सन हु इज प्लेइंग इट इज ऑलवेज चर्निंग द ओशन, इज नेवर एट रेस्ट, बिकॉज इज एवरी टाइम इज पुटिंग अ स्टेप, देयर वाज ऑलवेज टू पॉसिबिलिटीज एंड ही हैज टू मेक अ डिसीजन वेयर टू गो, एंड दैट विल ड्रॉ आउट डायरेक्शन विच द ट्री ऑफ द ड्रग विल फ्लो आउट.
या द How do you see, I mean, there's a lot of change that has happened, even in the Drupad, for example, the way it has been sung, the way accompaniment happens, for example. I call them petty stereotyping has also happened from within the music fraternity. We think Pakhavaj is there, but the way Pakhavaj used to be has been murdered, has been destroyed. Because Pakhavaj used to, it used to be rhythm and laya unleashed. It was not a, now it has become a pet. When I, for example, see very docile patterns being played, it's playing subservient pattern, role. जैसे ख्याल में इफ यू लुक एट एनी फॉर्म ऑफ म्यूजिक एक्चुअली यू नो एट टाइम्स वी सी सिंगर्स एट देवर रोल यू नो इवन इन द पास्ट देवर सॉर्ट ऑफ समटाइम्स थिंग्स वुड टर्न बिटर इफ द प्रकाशन इज प्लेड एंड गॉट द ब्रावोज फ्रॉम द ऑडियंस द सिंगर्स वुड रियली बी फ्यूरियस दैट ओ यू नो दे वुड फील जेलस देर वर स्टोरीज यू नो ऑफ भाई अर्जुन सिंह तरंगड़ एंड पंडित काशीनाथ काशीनाथ वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट द्रुपदियाज ऑफ यू नो ऑफ साउथ एशिया इंडिया डजंट इवन रिमेंबर पंडित काशीनाथ वॉज फ्रॉम द यू नो 1920s लेटर 20s एंड भाई अर्जुन सिंह तरंगड़ वॉज एट हिज यू नो almost at his peak, he'd become one of the greatest phenomenons already. And it was a, you know, in front of thousands of people, as there was a spat on the stage. It used to be there, but then it was a spectacular spat. I mean, people would be pushing each other to touch newer heights. But nowadays I see, for example, instruments playing a, they are not independent. They are not flourishing. If you look at Pakhavaj, mostly the thekas being played, like in Khayal and others, it is only, I mean, one wonders then why, what is the use of just keeping a cycle? Then you don't really need a cycle if it is only that. But the evolution of percussion, for example, was that the baj which played with asthai was different. The way the Pakhavaj was played with the first stanza was different. Then if you came back to the asthai, if you came back, there was an etiquette. I mean, I, as a someone who serves the oldest school of percussion of South Asia with the memory, which has not been even tapped or researched fully, and that is work yet happening, work with S.K. Saxena and all that. We did a lot of work and he rewrote his essays that he wrote, his book as well. If the asthai after the first stanza was only a one line, let's say you were only playing the first line and then going to the next stage of the Drupad, they would deal the mukhas differently. But if you chose to play the whole asthai after the antara, there was a way of playing of dupakki dugar and all that. Sanchari, it took me to reveal 25 whatever years ago, 30 years ago, that in Sanchari the ar quad used to be played. Technically, that's how it has been played in the Gurbani Sangeet tradition, the Rabar Sahib still, that is the memory that we have. And in the Abhog, the Tigan or the Pakki Tigan compositions, Tigan is not Teen Gun, it was a Tija Darja of Dugan and Tigan, the double of that, but there were patterns, these compositions used to be played. Point I'm making is, as a Drupad singing and playing, instruments have become very docile. Percussions, for example, percussion that was played with the which had developed an etiquette over centuries. How do you see? But of course, you know, me and you, we are born
not too far apart. By the time we were gaining our bearings, things had died already. But thankfully, by way of my association with people who were born in 1900 or 1890s and 1900s, it was the first decade, they were able to introduce and so on. But how do you see the change? And do you think we need to work hard to bring back that? Or is it okay the way it is?
I think the specific way the gharana goes will decide how the pathavaj will be or the all the tabla will be. See, like for the kind of alap, jod and jhala I am playing, I cannot have a very drut kind of pathavaj because it sets a very different tone. I would prefer to have a very vilambit kind of a pathavaj. Isme kran, dha, dha, dhin, aise jo teda chal raha hai na, aise. It's like a entire river slowly moving here and there. So I think jo baas aapne kiya na, uske the style of playing will dictate what the pathavaji or the accompanying tabla fiddle will do. Because there is a certain flow from the alap, jod and jhala into the composition, and that flow has to be maintained by the pathavaji. Otherwise it's like a strike in between. Unless you take a break and then you do the second piece and say, okay, we can do this, we can play around with this, we can play around. I think that's how we have been taught. So for my father would say, iske saath, there are a lot of people who are playing the drut stuff. There are a lot of people playing this and that. You practice with the vilambit because nobody is doing that. You do that. How do we go with the vilambit? Usme alap bhi dikhna chahiye and pakhavach ka, jisim, you should not know that the pakhavach is moving. Is it giving the theka or is it improvising? But you cannot pinpoint that it's giving the theka, but it's still improvising like that. Usme tali khali ka vazan bhi dikhna chahiye. So this is what we wanted basically.
But
so as far as we are concerned, we like somebody who is not, of course I do play with some pakhavajis who like really bang on. It is a good change at time. But more and more I'm getting into the alap, more I feel that this should be another way of doing this. Where to go with the veena, because you see pakhavaj also has a whole lot of overtones, and I like it if the pakhavaj, the ta and the dha, the overtones are mixing with the overtones of the ra. So that's what I am looking for. A whole lot of other people are looking at other things. So if we say ki asthaimi, of course that research has been done ki asthaimi aisa baja hai, the shuruaat, the first phrase has been played in a certain manner. But then I think situations change and newer ways of thinking are always been put in. Definitely somebody will go back to what you have mentioned. Once they reach to that kind of a plane, then they will want that kind of, because I think necessity is the mother of all inventions. So when you reach over there, then you want that, then you can't take anything less.
Mm.
That's how I look at it.
Yeah. So just to add to that, that in the, I mean, I'm going back before the gharana systems came into being, when there was genre, there was a Dhrupad as a genre. That is how you find compositions, for example, people from different Vanis singing, most of them also singing, everybody knew, for example, Khandarvani compositions. In people who were singing Gurvani, I mean, I have got some rare Swami Haridas compositions which I've checked, you know, over the decades now, which are not even known by others, in Balshari and others, you know, 3-note, 2-note, 4-note ragas and so on so forth, Tanzen's compositions and so on so forth, and several Nayaks and others. And Gurbani was remembered. In fact, Alabande Rahimuddin Khan Sahab's diary has a shabad from Gurbani, Pritam Jan Lehu Manamahi, and so on so forth. So it was much more eclectic. Learning was much more open, in the sense it was like an ocean which everybody could take his or her boat and fish out jewels. There was nothing, no divides were there. But to add to what you were saying, that there are compositions as I've shared in one of the bataks or maybe a couple of times, that Bhai Arjan Singh, Ustad Bhai Arjan Singh Tarangad would tell that when your, you know, he would tell me when your great grand uncle would be, Baba Jwala Singh would be singing this composition, it was the playing of sannata with it. Ke edinal sannata vajda si, edinal theka vini vajda. So it is the playing of the theka, but it is as if silence is being played. So it is not that it was to do with any particular, but there were compositions. It was all sort of necessity, as you said, but necessity of the bandish. There was a gunjayish within a bandish, if it was a viras, if not. There was repertoire that matched. People who knew thousands of compositions, and if there was a composition that was going in a very vilambit and a very gentle way, the mazmoon is, for example, aradhana, is full of aradhana in that particular aspect. There was repertoire that was played, but it did not mean that it was only the way, it was a very docile kind of playing. So I thought I'll just add to this conversation.
It was not, I mean, usually we think that slow is docile, but usme aise jaise kran aise maar diya na, ki lay aise hil jati thi. You know, they would put that kran or even dha, you would put in such a weight and in such a manner that the entire, the matra would shift front and back. Aadmi ki taali chhut jati thi. You know, people were not able to count.
Yeah.
So it's like an off dha, and it would press in and go. So that would create a different kind of a thing. But normally now everybody is playing adgun.
Very matra, very matrik. It has become very matrik. What, of course, the what we've shared.
Have compositions like
the meerdar chalan that used to be. Yeah, the one, for example, yeah, typically Amritsari Baj. Which Professor Saxena called willed waywardness, that it is going, but it is not straight, but it is willed to go wayward, something that he added.
So, for example, if we have this composition, Eri Har Gunthavo Fulan Ki Jame Pas Avat Mada Atarki Karpa Karat Piya Galehi Lagavat Kuchki Angi Atarki. Bakshu ka composition. There has to be an improvisation. And more and more, between my father and my uncle and our side, we are choosing to go by this now. Because this is like a rare thing now. Also for the veena and the voice to come together, I think this is one area where we think there is a lot of scope. Because the raag dari shuddhata is there, then you have the rasmayata, then you have the like go tha vo phulana ke ja me pa sa. If there is a vistar which is like this, then you have faster compositions where isko thoda aap le thoda sa madhya le karke you can sing it, and then the speed will again go like, you know, it's like a sway a little bit here and there. But in the beginning, it's more like an alap base, because for us, Alap is the main thing we want to do. Because the video has given so much detail between the dha and the ni, and like I was doing the nishad in the Kamboji, and then doing the higher nishad, and then doing the hitting the upper kakli nishad and coming back to dha, and then just andolaning the dha to show that there is a ni, suggesting a ni, but not actually having a ni and going back to the pa. So I want to keep this towards the all the way to the end. So we are looking for a pakhavaji who will do something with this, you know. So yes, we just go like a tack, change of track over here suddenly. So I think the style in which you want to do is going to definitely dictate what you want.
But for example, like Baiju's composition, any old ones, at that time thekas never used to be played in a performance, for example.
No.
So how the habits have become today is not, I mean, we are sort of, there was ways, I mean, I maybe one day we can sit together when I have, you know, the skin to beat and you have a string to pull. We will look at these, and I have, you know, there are compositions or patterns that would be played with these kind of compositions. So there was one more thing that used to happen, because aesthetics is gone out, because nothing remains static, the monotony comes in. The first time, for example, when you play the asthai, the chair is, which is no longer remembered by the Indian pakhavaj systems, is the playing of the vilambit baj with the asthai when it first is recited, and sometimes I've played. So it'll, for example, when you start, so dha ge 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 dha ge 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 dha ge ge dha din ta ge ge dha ge 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 dha ge ge de te dha ge ge dha ge ge dha ge ge dha ge 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 de te dha ge ge dha di ta ge ge dha di ta ge ge dha ge ge de te dha ge ge dha di ta ke na dha di ta ke dha di ke na dha dum dum na te tre ta ka ka tridhe te te dha ge ge dha ge ge dha ge ge dha tit krde tet katta gedi genna da kena nak trde ta ta ge trde ta gedi genna da di da kena nak trde ta ta ge trde ta gedi genna da di da kena nak trigde ta tage trigde ta gaddi genna da di da. You know, this is, for example, how it used to be played in the asthai, which is gone. This baj doesn't exist in the Indian pakhava system. So when your father or my, you know, our previous generation is responding, they're only responding to the pakhava, they're listening. Now it is only dha, dha, dhinta, dhanidhra, dhanidhra, straight. There's no idea of progression how the Dhrupad format evolved from asthai till abhog, from the first sthai, you know, from the first sam to the akhri sam. There was an evolution. But when the asthai, for example, has already been rendered like this, the text has been sung, now the audience, which is very literate, which understands the idea ke ek baat do baat kahi gayi, jaise for example aap mujhe bhojan khila rahe hain, aapne ek bar bhojan khilaya mere ko
और आप कहें कि कैसा, अच्छा लगा, मैं कहूंगा हाँ बहुत बढ़िया था, बहुत मजा आया। अब दो मिनट बाद आप फिर कहें कि अच्छा भोजन कैसा लगा, मैं कहूंगा मैंने आपसे जिक्र किया कि बहुत बढ़िया था। फिर आप मुझे पांच मिनट में फिर अच्छा भोजन कैसा था, मैं कहूंगा यार टिकाने पे हो कितनी बार पूछोगे, याददाश्त है कि नहीं। सो दिस आइडिया ऑफ मोनोटोनी वॉज डिस्ट्रॉयड। सो वेन यू हैव ऑलरेडी एस्टैब्लिश्ड दी, बिकॉज इट इज नॉट जस्ट ए मेलोडी लाइन, इट इज ए टेक्स्ट एंड द टेक्स्ट इज सेइंग समथिंग। द टेक्स्ट इज इट्स एन आर्ग्यूमेंट और ए थीसिस, whether it's an, whether it may be even a eulogy, it may be a tarif ki he mahadeen kya ala abja बहाउद्दीन क्या आला बजावत। अगर आ गया अगली बार आ रहा हूं मैं, आफ्टर दी स्टैंजा फॉर एग्जाम्पल इट कुड बी अगर ये चला उसमें उठान चली अंतरे की, दुगुन की उठान चलती थी। जैसे आपने कहा छपका कहते थे लोग, भूल गए कि छपका क्या होता है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल क्रां जो बोल है यानी कि दुगुन की एक रसम होती थी कि अंतरा उठा उसको भरना कैसे है पखावज में। बट देन इफ यू केम बैक टू दी अस्थाई इट वुड बी दी पक्की दुगुन बिकॉज दे आर नॉट ट्राइंग टू ब्रेक अवे फ्रॉम द मोनोटोनी। के एक बात आपने कह दी कि यार खाना बड़ा अच्छा था, वो दूसरी बार अब कहा जाएगा पर जैसे कहा जाएगा आपका आपको ये ना लगे कि यार रिपीट हो रहा है। So there was a aesthetical solution, मतलब aesthetics के perspective से there were solutions that were discovered and recovered or enacted. That discourse has died. It is not just about static.
I mean, it has died also because of the discourse and also I think something. I think the time limit of the performance is also kind of killed it.
I think we have killed it. Ignorance has killed it because time. I would not agree there because Vidwan as please continue. Allow me to just say this and please continue after that. I just want to say that a Vidwan, you know, 3 minute ke there were 3 minute records. A Vidwan was who could you know render जैसे मरम रूप जैसे पुरानी कहावत है कि एक स्वर में दूसरे स्वर में तीसरे स्वर में राग एस्टैब्लिश हो जाना चाहिए, राइट? सो आई थिंक ए विद्वान हु इज एबल टू हु नोज द राग, हु नोज द बंदिश एंड हु आल्सो नोज द प्रकर्शन इज एबल टू एस्टैब्लिश इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द टाइम। बट प्लीज कंटिन्यू।
बट इट रिक्वायर्स अ विद्वान टू डू दैट।
यस।
सो इफ नॉट एवरीबॉडी इज गोइंग टू बिकम अ विद्वान, यू सी पीपल डू अ लॉट ऑफ रियाज बट sadhana is something else. Vidwans have done their sadhanas, so it's very different. Like you know, if I just look at my playing two lines of rag, the third line I would not be able to intake it because it would be so heavy and my mind would be full for a month with it. So vidvata ki baat, it's not everywhere. I mean, there are brilliant players and there are very intelligent players, but vidvata is something else. When it is a kind of a sadhana, which jiska lakshya pehle se hi set hota hai, wo aadmi bolta hai ki mujhe is disha mein jana hai. He's not there for the audience or he's not there to show how much he's known. He's there. He's like he's is enjoying that moment. And there is an accompanist with him, a pakhavaji or a tabla player, with, there is a kind of a chemistry between them. Then all that you are talking is going to come around. But also that chemistry doesn't happen every time. It will happen. Sometimes it will be so beautiful, and sometimes it will be great, but it will not go beyond a certain thing.
I see.
I mean, if we decide from the beginning, ye karna, ye karna, it's not going to happen.
Yeah. I see one.
But lakshya, agar aap keh rahe ho ki aise baja rahe hai aap, ye ab jo apne bol pade the, aisa bajana hai. Agar yehi lakshya raha, and it takes years to go there, no?
Yeah, yeah.
It's not, even if I am playing the alap and people are saying, oh, you're playing, it has taken me. I remember how my beginning as an alap was. I mean, it was as to hide after my concerts. You know, I didn't want to meet people, or I didn't want to hear anything. If someone said you played well, I knew where I was exactly. So I didn't want to do that. So it takes time. It's for maturity, for a, you know. And somehow I think in today's time people think that, okay, it's just a concert, let's play this, cut it out, because if I play this and this, my next concert is ensured. I will get my next one if the organizer is happy, if the audience is happy. So what you're talking about is an absolutely different ball game. It is wo jo rasmayta jo lani hai, it's a different level of thinking. And it takes time and years and patience of people to gel together, put their ideas together, discover, listen to each other's work. I mean, the main musician, if you call him the main, he has to listen to what the Pakhavaji's gharana is, what is his ideology, what does he want to improvise, how does he want to improvise, is there something he wants to say. So this interaction can happen only over a lot many years of being with each other, fighting with each other, agreeing, disagreeing, yet being friends, you know, then this is going to happen.
Yeah. There's some person called Vishan Lal says, Bhai ji, please give more time to the guest artist. I said there's some gentleman or a gentle lady called Vishan Lal says, Bhai ji, please give more time to the guest artist. And I've deliberately chosen to address this, that Vishan Lal ji, I wonder who's the guest. Am I the guest in Palaspe at Bahauddin's place, or is Bahauddin my guest? You must look at the content of what is being said, because what I'm sharing with you all, since 1947, India has forgotten. I'm reminding India what Indian music used to be. So look at the content and of what is being said. This is not about giving more time. There is no time limit. You all have to be patient and see what the conversation is happening, what a preamble is being constructed, what is being shared, what is it that the where is it that we are headed in a conversation. So instead of me writing a comment later or ignoring it, I would rather, for everybody's sake, that it is not about, because we start the time, we have a time when we begin the conversation. These conversations are not to be only for 15 minutes or 20 minutes. The guests who are very dear to me, they have all the time that they need to respond. So I hope that this will just rest the case once and for all. To come back to what you were saying about the is that as I was mentioning, the discourse is missing. But one thing which I see with some pain is that they were always like that. People who had peripheral knowledge, that means who dealt in compositions, who would just be going around collecting compositions, pakhavaj ki compositions, gaane ki compositions, and so on and so forth. As Fahim Sahab, you know, Papa Sahab would ask me, yehi Nizamuddin mein ek baar sair kar rahe, I think it was 98 or 9, and he around in the night around 2 o'clock, and he said, hey Baldipa, you never ask for compositions, you're the only one I have met that you come and discuss this and that, you talk of ragas, you do comparisons between the old compositions, Saxena, me and you, Pai Sikandar Singh Bagriya and Dr. Subhuti Patadkar,
Is it? But you never ask because everybody else comes and says, "Mujhe ye bandish, I need this composition, that composition." You never do that. I said, "Baba Sahab, my grand, you know, from the Gurbani Sangeet, I've got like, I don't want to, you know, say the number. It's thousands of compositions. I don't want, just for the sake of these, you know, honor, not to be seen as if a boast. That there are so many compositions that if I had 200 years hale and hearty with absolute good sense, I wouldn't have time to even practice them. So kis muh se, with what face do I come and say I need more? Because if you were to ask me pehle kitna sikha, usko sunao, so I won't have, you know, I would say, well, I've been working on this and I haven't yet done this. So, and he had a moist eye. But the point I'm making is that the advantage that people who are closely associated with a big tradition, closely associated means they are not only in the peripheral conversations. They are in the core center. Mm-hmm. Like you've got several Guru Bhais who were more than a child to your own father and to your uncle, right? So you exactly know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about too in that sense. So those people, the discourse is different. It is also about the other truths and not just the mechanics or the tangible or the not just the lash of music, no? Ke raag ki, bandish ki lash, ya, whether it is a singing or a pakhavaj composition, isn't it? So the discourse, that discourse is missing ki application kaise hoti thi. For example, langar lagana, the other day only, one of the baithaks, the idea of langar lagana was that I shared ke langar lagate the, anchor jaise karte hain. So for example, if you're playing a composition, but if the Pahavji would, for example, see that something subtle is happening while singing or on the taus or the veena or the saranda, etc. Right? And from the dirgha playing, suddenly it will become soft. So they could have been playing, for example, it will be just like a resonance as if. And then they would see jagah dekhna ke ab kahan sthayi kahan sam dikhane lage hain. Jahan pe langar chala 10 cycle, 10 cycle, 15 cycle, 18 cycle, depending on the mizaz of the gavaiya or the vajantri, and then they would see ke ab, you know, ab vajan badla hai, ab asthai ka sam dikhayega ya antar, ab ye mukam lagayega. And Tarangat sahab would tell Pairaj Singh Tarangat that the actual Pakhavaji is the one who would anticipate ke ab jo hai sam dikhane ja rahe hai. And then you begin from there, nakad de de takad da da kad de de dharan usko fir agla fir makan lena uska fir vazandar sam pe laake dena kehte karishma wo kehlata tha, karishma wo hota tha. So point I'm making is the conversation again, this gentleman is born in 1900, so people who were born in the 1920s, 30s, 40s, my own father's generation had no idea the discourse, because I think partition played a big role. People were not able to carry on certain information. I think that wherever the conversation is about ke mere ko ye aata hai, and it is just like a majboori ke ye bajana hi kyunki mujhe aata hai, wo ye nahi dekhte ki bandish ki zarurat kya hai, us waqt gawaiye ka ya vajantri ka mizaj kahan pahuncha hai, samadhi lag rahi hai ya kya lag raha hai. So I thought that I'll
that would decide definitely what, because you know, that presence of mind and that oneness doesn't come by a few concerts. He has to spend time with him, eating, sitting, discussing his work, knowing about the other's work. You know, how does he think? How does he bring this about? I mean, for an example, I met Pandit Shiv Kumar Sharmaji on a flight, and I was talking to him about accompaniment. And I said, I have seen a whole lot of people accompany with you. They were really marvelous accompanies. I said, but when it comes to Ustad Zakir Hussain with you, I said, it feels like there is something else. You know, he's like tipping toe on everything you're doing. He said, yes, you know, he said he had one habit. He said, after I finished my concert, he would take the recording of the concert and we would do a tour, like 6-7 concerts, like every second day So for 2 days, he would be listening to that concert again and again. What I have played, where I have played, where I put the weightage, where I have, and the next time he would anticipate that immediately. Mm. So I mean, it is a lot of work.
Yeah.
It is a lot of. It is not just what he wants to play.
Mm.
You know, if like when the Pakhawaji or the accompanist comes in, he is going to take your concert to another level.
Mm.
So he has to be. He has to be so mindfulness. He has to be totally aware of what this guy is, how he has begun, and how the beginning is going to change the way the entire theme is going to flow ahead, and what is he going to do next.
Mm.
If he listens to the alap, he will know what is going to happen in the chala, in the jod, and then the entire thing, if he keeps a picture in the mind, he knows exactly how the composition is going to be. Because even if you sing a composition, just sing the line, the vistar will depend on how the alap, jod and the jhala is going to be. That will dictate, definitely. So if the Pakhawaji has not listened to your alap, jod and jhala, there is no way he is going to feel like one.
Yeah.
So that is, and similarly, I mean, if he is doing the theka or you're giving him a chance to play in between, you have to listen to what he's doing, because sometimes he's coming out with a new idea, and then with that idea, your improvisation is there is a connect on that idea of how you will take the next phrase off. So this this cannot happen always. It happens sometimes. It can happen with an extremely great player. At the same time, it can happen with an extremely average player.
Mm.
That chemistry, where it's going to fit, you cannot decide. Sometimes the most normal Pakhawajis have played a concert and you look at them and say, wow, this guy was there on the spot.
Mm. Yeah. A couple
apart
of,
from and yeah, yeah. having knowledge.
Didi, it's very interesting. Tarangad, by Arjun Singh, Tarangad would say that Pakhawaji, avval Pakhawaji ho hai jada antarjami hove. Ke gawaiye di vajantri di bojh lave. ਇੱਕ ਕਦਮ ਅੱਗੇ ਰਵੇ ਕਿ ਉਹ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਜਾਏਗਾ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਐਂਟੀਸਪੇਟ ਕਰਦਾ ਜਾਵੇ ਦਿਸ ਇਜ਼ ਤਰੰਗੜ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਹੈਵ ਨਾਟ ਹਰਡ ਦਿਸ ਕਾਈਂਡ ਆਫ ਇਨਸਾਈਟਸ ਫਰੋਮ ਐਨੀਬਡੀ ਐਲਸ ਐਂਡ ਸਕਸੈਨਾ ਦੈਟਸ ਵਾਈ ਸਕਸੈਨਾ ਵਾਜ਼ ਲਾਈਕ ਟੋਟਲੀ ਐਂਡ ਬਾਬਾ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਆਲਸੋ ਯੂਜ਼ ਟੂ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਹੀਅਰ ਕਿ ਕਿਆ ਕਿਆ ਬਾਤਾਂ ਅਬ ਕਿਆ ਬਤਾਇਆ ਸੋ ਹੀ ਲਿਵਡ ਔਨ ਐਟ ਦੀ ਏਜ ਆਫ ਅੰਟਿਲ ਦੀ ਏਜ ਆਫ 95 ਐਂਡ ਲਾਸਟ 5 ਇਅਰਸ ਇਜ਼ ਵੈਰੀ ਮਾਈ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਹੀ ਮੈਂਟਰਡ ਮੀ ਐਂਡ ਟੋਟ ਮੀ ਯੂ ਟੁੱਕ ਕਪਲ ਆਫ ਨੇਮਸ Pandit Shiv Kumar Sharma, he's a man of extraordinary humility. His father, Pandit Uma Dutt Ji, studied with my Dada Guru, Ustad Harnam Singh of Jammu Court. He was a cabinet, he was a major, one of the greatest legends, who along with Shambhu Singh and Parbat Singh used to practice together with Baba Kadau Singh, the first three elders. Because Baba Kadau Singh's grand teacher is Baba Maiya Singh. People don't know again. Baba Maiya Singh is the chief court musician at Maharaja Ranjit Singh's court, and I have the pagdi of Baba Maiya Singh, and he was given a jagir, Maiya ke jagir, and your ancestor Baba Behram Khan also is at the Lahore Darbar. So imagine, like a conversation that we are having is as if our lines of knowledge have been conversant with each other. And Shiv Kumar Ji's humility, when at the Sangeet Nadak Academy went, when I just told him, I said, do you know that your father, that your grand teacher is also my grand teacher and I'm a pakdi. He took my hands and placed his head. He's a man of such humility, that such regard of parampara and of etiquette. Aajkal ke logon ko tehzeeb nahi, malum nahi hai logon ko uske baare mein. But I think the uniqueness about, the reason I mentioned about Shiv Kumar Ji is that the quality of learning of Baba Harnam Singh and his father and others, I mean, it's that in the DNA. The way you see the layer, the way you touch the note, when to alter the beat and when to touch the note in the degree, in that hue, in the shade, that Rasva Dirgha Polita, that is a sanskar that is not easily gotten. Otherwise, it is like only, as Saxena would often say, ki classwork or homework ki kitab leke stage pe baith jate hain log. You know, the bloom has not yet occurred, the fragrance is not yet there. People are just carrying the bouquet they got and just polishing it, showing it. I think it is a lot of flowering, and it
requires, you cannot be inventing a wheel. I think what Zakir Hussain ji is doing is again part of the sanskar, is part of the education that you have to listen, because you cannot teach somebody to listen, because it requires a different junoon chahiye sunne ke liye, ek aashiqui chahiye sunne ke liye na, ek mohabbat chahiye, ek khichao chahiye, lagan chahiye, otherwise you cannot tell somebody, arey fir se suno.
There was an interview of Ustad Zakir Hussain where he talks about how his father used to wake him up at 3 o'clock in the morning aur sirf bol padte the unko, not allow him to touch. For 2 hours you just keep on saying the bols, and he said, I kept on listening to them, and then when I understood them, I started the practice to play them. He didn't learn to play them, he learned to understand and listen to them. It's like when Ustad used to teach us, he used to say, isko dekho, you know, इसको कहो, डोंट सिंग इट, से इट, लुक एट इट, यू नो, डोंट प्ले इट, देखो ये कैसे जा रहा है, अनलेस एंड अनलेस अ विजुअल इज नॉट फॉर्मड इन द आई, इन द माइंड, कि ऐसे रेखा ऐसे जाके यू जा रही, इफ देयर इज नो नैरेटिव यू कैन नॉट गेट इनटू दैट, सो दैट फॉर दैट नैरेटिव टू हैपन इट टेक्स टाइम आई थिंक, एंड वंस दैट नरेशन स्टार्ट्स हैपनिंग देन, एंड द अनदर थिंग इन द लैकारी इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज नॉट द not the beats, but the pulse, you know, that pulse, 1, 2, that is very important. Agar gati hai uski sahi rahegi, aur uski agar aapne vilambit mein a dhi ta dhi, ab is lay mein agar aapne kaam kiya, do aavartan apne theka dhare, aur uske baad then एक बार लय कायम होगी, देन वॉट एवर यू डू, इफ यू डोंट प्ले द ठेका, इट विल बी देयर. द प्रॉब्लम अराइजेस व्हेन द लय गोस फ्रंट
या बैक, पीपल हैव डोंट, पीपल डोंट हैव, आई हैव हैड टू सिंग एट टाइम्स व्हेन आई वाज सिंग, द परकशनिस्ट वुड टेंड टू रश द कंपोजिशन टू द लेवल वेयर दे आर कंफर्टेबल विद प्लेइंग, वेयर देयर कंपोजिशंस फिट इन. Because I see, and me and Fahim Saab used to discuss a lot after radio programs and so on and so forth, because we would be always analyzing aesthetically, and he would always be crying, the car from the radio, he would be reviewing, "Arey Valdeepa, you know, I was starting the composition here, why do they rush?" and so on and so forth. So it was again the absence of that repertoire. I think there's a big problem. That's why I said that I think a lot of disco, and the reason why I'm conversing, spending so much time talking about this idea, because you see, it's a collective, it's a charisma of a collective, as I'm fond of saying. It is not just about playing, because Pahavaj or any, even the Tanpura, anything that there is, even a person's mizaz, that is also part of the collective. Tabiyat, tehzeeb, sanskar, you know, whether you're an arrogant bee on stage, or you're a flower in bloom, you know, you're a fragrant fellow. That is very, very important. Lay ka jo samajhna hai, but I think it's not part of the pedagogy now. It's not part of the pedagogy.
No, but what I have also done is sometimes I, you know, like some people, like if it was Manik Munde ji or Pandit Shrikant Mishra ji or not, sometimes I listen to what lay they are standing in, because sometimes unki lay itni achhi rehti hai कि आप उस लय में आप चालू हो जाते हो. सो आई ऑल्सो गो टू द अदर साइड एंड मेक श्योर दैट, बिकॉज यू नेवर नो, यू कैन नॉट ऑलवेज बी राइट, यू नो, समटाइम्स यू फील दिस इज वेरी नाइस, एंड देन आई टेल देम कि प्लीज रिमेंबर दिस लय ऑन द स्टेज, यू बिगिन द ठेका विद दिस, देन आई विल बिगिन द कॉम्पोजिशन, बिकॉज इट्स समटाइम्स दैट धा, द फर्स्ट धा सेट समथिंग, समटाइम्स द फर्स्ट नोट सेट समथिंग, सो दैट डिसीजंस हैव टू बी मेड ऑन दोस थिंग्स.
Yeah,
and that you have to have an open playground to do both of these things.
But then, you know, you get into a fix, because like my grand uncle Pai Avtar and Pai Gurcharan would say, this composition goes in this space and you cannot change it. So there was another discourse nowadays we see that. So I think
some of the compositions are like
exactly
that.
And then
some compositions are like that, you know, but you cannot speed them or you cannot slow them.
Yeah, they have that pace, and then it requires the percussionist, for example, to learn that.
Ek desi ka hai, तुम जाने तुम इसको इसी लय में करना पड़ता है, वो लटक जाती है. तो कुछ कॉम्पोजिशन इवन मेरे फादर वॉज टीचिंग उदय जी और सम अदर पीपल, यू वुड से इसको इस लय में लाना है. For that composition would be sung for a month or 2 months yeah. again. बोले नहीं, क्योंकि बोले the way my father would teach was very strange. He would say हम ताली नहीं देंगे. ओ धो तुम जाइए कहीं और पा सहू. तो बोले ताल कौन से, दे वुड आस्क सम स्टूडेंट्स ये कौन से साइकिल में, बोले तुमको साइकिल से क्या मतलब है, ये बराबर अपने आप बैठा हुआ है, इसको पहले बोले इसका कटिंग और इसका टाइमिंग सही करना, फिर मैं तुमको बता दूंगा. उसमें बैठा हुआ है और बराबर उसमें बैठा होता था, एक फ्रैक्शन यहाँ से वहां ही जाता है. तो दिस इज अ डिफरेंट वे ऑफ. So then what happens there is you are free of that va do tum ja ye kahi to bolte na matra dikh raha nahi.
Ha, matrik bajana ho raha hai na, this is a big jhanjhat.
So matra dikh rahi hai. Ha,
hamare
to so take time just to learn composition and then it would be in, because in his mind it was clear ki ye dhamar aise iski lay ye hai yahan baithi hai, wo dhamar uski lay है, वो थोड़ी यहाँ पर है, उसको वहीं पर करना है. तो इसमें विस्तार यू करते हैं कि ये कॉम्पोजिशन है मेक का प्रबल अदरस, ये विलंबित में हो रहा है और ये द्रुत में ऐसे जाएगा. तो कुछ कॉम्पोजिशन विलंबित में भी हो गए, तो उस में बोलेगी ऐसे भी चलेगी. सो दैट यू नो उसमें वो लयकारी में उसको ऐसे रखते थे कि मात्रा नहीं गिनना है बट उसका स्वे कहाँ है. बिकॉज इवन इन द बिगिनिंग वी हैड ट्रबल वी ट्राइड टू कीप द लय एंड ऑल दैट. मोटी जी यूज्ड टू टेल मी कि देखो धा 1 2 3 दिस अ इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. देन योर वंस योर लय इज प्रॉपर व्हेन योर मीटर इज राइट then you can fit 15, 16, 14, it's not an issue. But it's been 3 khali ho gaya, it's been 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So, then the time sign, then you can see time as like a, or the taal as a circular thing, not a linear thing. So that when you have this kind of discussions with the accompanists and all that, then I think it opens up yeah. into something. And also to know what gharana they are coming, what is their speciality. They might not play that on the stage, but what do they play? What do usme kya hai, wo gidanaka kya hai, ya dhumakitaka kar rahe, ya unki speciality kya hai, what is he thinking about, how does he do the vistar. So it is a time spending thing, but if you spend time with it and I think it comes out into something really very, very beautiful. Mm. Like if you see Munde ji ki jo Guru ji the, Amarnath ki ke kya naam tha unka, Banaras se the.
Pandit Amarnath Mishra.
हाँ हाँ हाँ, जो पखावज बजाते थे ना, जो वो अखाड़ा भी चलाते थे.
हाँ बिल्कुल. संकट मोचन हाँ, वो अपने.
संकट मोचन.
वीरभद्र मिश्र जी के अंकल
हाँ. उनका एक रिकॉर्डिंग है जो बीन बजाते थे लालमणि मिश्र जी के साथ. उसमें आप देखिए किरदाते धागे धागे टते टते ऐसे ऐसे जाते ही यू नो हिज प्लेइंग अ कंपोजिशन एंड इंडिपेंडेंटली इज वीविंग इन एंड आउट एंड इन एंड देन यू कैन सी द ताली एंड देन यू कैन सी द खाली एंड देन यू कैन सी द सम एंड देन इट्स अगेन गोइंग अप लाइक दैट बट you can't put it like a meter. So it's like this weaving through yeah. Like if you even listen to Begum Akhtar ji and Nizamuddin Khan sahab, they are both playing two different things. She's singing something else एंड ही इज प्लेइंग सम डिफरेंट डैम थिंग एंड वो ठेके पे बराबर सम पे आके ठक करके फिर वापस उठ के अपने घूम रहे हैं, दोनों ऐसे घूम रहे हैं फिर वापस आ रहे हैं. You know, but this takes, I mean, it takes two geniuses or two really parallel minds to,
In the Gurbani,
but obviously one tries to go into that, but it's...
In the Gurbani Sangeet Parampara also, the zarb, for example, the weight, the katao is strictly supposed to be on the shabd and the bhav of the shabd and the... Alankar that is associated in deciphering the content of the word. इतना मुश्किल है कि उसमें ज़र्ब, जैसे बड़ा अच्छा लगा मुझे जो तुमने एग्जाम्पल दिया कि अगर कोई कंपोजिशन लेते हैं फॉर एग्जाम्पल century composition gunanad dhuni anand ved yene ke gunanad dhona naise nahi chalega na dhoni anand ab anand galat ho gaya ye forbidden hai
jaise alag ho gaya.
So, ये मुझे बड़ी खुशी है सुन.
पिता जी बोलते कि वो शब्द सही जैसे हे र न ज टी त र त न र के अ वो श न छो तो इस तरह से वो कहाँ कट करना है क्योंकि भाव पक्ष है उसपे उसके उसका एक कन्वेइंग हो रहा है कि क्या हो रहा है यहाँ पर. फिर उसको थोड़ा सा बदलोगे तो उसका भाव बदल गया. उसी तरह से फिर विस्तार चालू हो रहा है. तो पहले एक उसको उन्होंने कहते थे कि एक फ्रेमवर्क स्केलेटन की तरह होना चाहिए उस रागदारी का, राग स्वरूप का और उस पोएट्री का. उसके बाद आप उसके ऊपर विस्तार करो. फिर आप पर एक एक हरकत हर बाल की बारी सी भी की तो ऐसा लगता है कि विस्तार शुरुआत हुआ. तो आई थिंक ऑल दिस थिंग्स इवन इन द अलाप यू कीपिंग इन माइंड कि रस्व दीर्घ फ्लूइड क्या है, शब्द कैसे इस्तेमाल किए जा रहे हैं उसको. रे तो उसमें हस्त कौन से इस्तेमाल हो रहे हैं तो ये सब ध्यान में रखना पड़ता है. दैट इज वाई वी कॉल इट शास्त्रीय संगीत. ये प्रमाण हाथ का इतना करंगी इस्तेमाल की, सूची मुद्रा इस्तेमाल की कि आपने आ का है आ ये इसका अर्थ अलग हो गया. हर हमेशा आप एक मूड बना उससे मूड आई वुडंट यूज द वर्ड वो एक उसमें एक विस्तार पैदा कर रहे हैं. तो कैसे करेंगे, शब्द से करेंगे, स्वर से करेंगे, हस्त से करेंगे, आघात से करेंगे, क्लिंदर इस्तेमाल करेंगे, जो भी क्रिया हो है उसके लिए टाइमिंग और कटिंग वॉज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट बोथ ऑफ उस्ताद टॉक अबाउट. इसको यहाँ से कट करो यहाँ से यहाँ तक लाके क्लिप कर दो, फिर यहाँ से इसको पकड़ के ले आना ऐसे, because it's like breathing, you know, you inhale, you stop and you exhale and you might not breathe for some time, but you continue to live. So those things are what we are trying to put into the composition again from the alap straight away, instead of trying to go on with the role that people do.
बीज स्वरूप से मरम तक का सफर है ना. Mostly we see people caught in the बीज स्वरूप, बीज रूप सिंगिंग. The lean रूप, for example, is gone. I mean, people don't understand anymore the idea of the lean, and things have become very sthool in that sense.
I think sometimes people understand. Mm-hmm. I think many times or sometimes people understand, but they don't want to do it. They just think we'll just go away with the new pace of life and you know what's happening nowadays. They just think ye kaun sunega, unko lagta hai. But I think it's important that people listen to it. People know that something else also exists besides what's happening.
Yeah. Acha, to come to your dad and your uncle. I have learned from someone very close to you that you're playing the Rudravina because you tried to play the harmonium, because you failed at playing the harmonium is why you picked up the Veena. Is there a truth in that?
Well, I actually speaking, I never picked up the Rudravina. When I became 16, then I realized, you know, I went for this America Festival of India tour with my father playing Tanpura behind. Mm-hmm. 4 months I was with both my father and my uncle playing Tanpura for both of them. And then I realized, my God, this is something that sets you free. It doesn't have a boundary. There's a framework, but you can work around the framework. So when I came back, I said, I want to learn this. Mm-hmm. My father said, "Acha, you want to learn?" I said, "Yeah, I want to learn, but I don't know if I should play the sitar, or I should play pakhawaj, or I should do dance, or I should do harmonium or anything." So,
Ek minute. You said dance?
I did. I mean, just as a question, you know. He said, "You play the Rudra Veena." I said, "Are you sure?" He said, "Yeah." He said, "You play the Rudra Veena." Mm. And then I just took to playing to the Rudra Veena. I didn't question, because there were no twos about it. Mm. You know, I knew that this man knew what my aptitude and attitude is, and like that.
So how was the what was the first sabak like? What was it to be at the feet of your dad?
The first sabak was, you forget that you are my son. Pehle shagird bano, then from this day onward you are not my son. He said, you are my student. And you behave like a student and I will teach you. You behave like a son, I will not be able to teach you even if I want to. That was the first thing. Second thing, he said, ye murchana hai, isko karo. Which of course, for a young man of 16, I didn't do, because I said, I will play the big rags. I thought, it's all laddu, just have it and enjoy it. So, that was it. And then there's Thai of Yaman, the two lines of Yaman. Uh-huh. And he said, do this. And I by-hearted them, and the next day, man, I played it for him. I said, kar liya. And he said, ho gaya. I said, haan, apne bataya, maine bacha liya. Bole, nahin, iska ek ghante ka alap hona hai, tab main samajh dunga ki tune theek se bajaya. I said, oh God. फिर आपने बताया नहीं, बोले नहीं, इसी यही बीज है, इसी के अंदर सब कुछ है. ये ठीक करेगा तो वो बढ़ते जाएगा, समय बिताओ उसके साथ. Then for a long time, you know, I mean, he didn't tell me, he didn't teach me. I used to be behind his back. Then once I got this vague two phrases, कि ये उसकी अस्थाई कैसी रहती है, और फिर दो phrases की बात बोले बस इतना ही है. तो मैंने बोला बाकी का, बोले बाकी का तुम समझ लेना. Then I started, you know, one day I was listening, there were some musicians of my age who were playing a lot of different rags and everything, and I was not getting it. And then I came to my father and I said, you know, there is this rag and there is Kaushik Kannada and that Vibhas is there and this and Deshkar, and he says, when will I learn all this? He said, तुम्हारा यमन हो गया? I said, नहीं हुआ. He said, उसको करो, जब वो हो जाएगा मैं ये भी बता दूंगा. And I said, this yaman is not going to ever happen. Because it's going to take a lifetime to understand this thing and to imbibe it, to bring it out. And then I asked him, how? I said, तो बाकी का राग का क्या करना है? I said, कुछ नहीं करना है. I said, तो फिर अगर वो भूल गया, तो बोले तुम्हारी तकदीर बहुत बुरी है अगर तुम भूल गए तो. He said, but you're not teaching me. I said, अगर, he said, अगर मैं तुमको सब कुछ सिखाऊंगा तो तुमके जिंदगी में तुम झक मारोगे, तुम क्या करोगे खुद? तुमको दो चीजें बताई गई है, उसी के ऊपर सब कुछ निर्भर है. Stick to that and you will reach where you want to reach. And slowly but surely, that happened. And within 4 or 5 years after that, my father passed away. So this was in 86, and 1990 September he passed away. And then I was like, oh my God, I have to sit and begin playing all this now. So I remember the first thing he said, Murchana Bharo. So I started playing with the Murchana again, again and again. Kuch mehne toh mehne Murchana ka.
I remember in Bhopal also, I have that memory.
Yeah. And then obviously I had some help because Pushparaj Koshi used to come home. Dada used to come home and say, sit with me and play. Chalo, bajao mere saath, baith ke bajao. And he used to make me play with him for hours and hours together. And he would never tell me, tumko ye nahi aata hai, wo nahi aata hai. Chalo, apan desh bajate hai. Dada, mujhe nahi aata hai. Nahi, nahi, bajao, kuch nahi, aise hota hai. And he, in his very, Pushparaj ji is a very mild, we call him Maryada.
But his name begins with a push.
Very gently.
But his name begins with a push.
Yeah.
He pushed you.
Push. Yeah. So he pushed me. And slowly he got into this, gently showing me, like I did do a lot of duets with him. So on the stage, I would be playing something and then something would go wrong. And I would look at him and he would very gently gesture to me, not like this, like that, and he's playing. So that's also how I learned. It was, then of course there was Ustad. So Ustad was a different word. If you tell him, Ustad, ye kaise hai? You ask him 1,000 things would be put in front of you. So Ustad, slow down, I can't take this. He says, nahin, sun le beta, kaam aayega kabhi. Yaad aayega tab kaam aayega. You, Ustad would say, mind is like a, it's like a computer. When it takes something, it will never forget it. You have to work towards it. When the right time comes, it will reveal itself. Mm-hmm. Slowly over the years, I learned slowly my repertoire from Yaman and Todi and Malkosh and Madhumanti expanded. It also expanded when I started doing the Murchana of Bhairav. Then a different set of rags came through, and then the journey started moving ahead.
So then, go ahead.
Then there came a point in time when I said I have to incorporate the words like ri ra ra na te ta, what, how, the sadharani giti ke shabd ka construction kaise hota hai, a ra na na ri na, to simple phrase, compound phrase, complex phrase, a na na te ta ra na ri na, ta ra na te ta ra na ri na, tra na ta ra na ta ra na ta ra na, to ye phrases kaise bante hain. To for this I actually had to sit with Manikal, and Manikal had learned this with my father. Yeah. And then he said, "Dekho, main tumko kuch batata hu jo tumhare pitaji se maine sikha, ye mera kartavya hai before I go show to you." And he showed me a ra na ri na ri ra ra na ri ra ra na na ri ra ra na ri ra ra na. To isko vistar kaise karte hain? So then I had to begin all over again,
right,
and then start singing about it, and then to bring it into playing, it took a lot of time. So every time I had to start, go back to zero and start over again. But that was really fun for me. I mean, it was rediscovering the entire thing in a new manner.
Can you sing these syllables that you shared? Why don't you demonstrate what Manikal was showing you?
Yeah. So so he said, first you begin like a ra na, akara hai, akar hai, akar nahi, to ra na बिंदु का शब्द है, ऐसे भी हो सकता है लेकिन ऋषभ ज्यादा नहीं लगेगी यमन पे उसने। अभी री रे ना, तो ई आ और अ, अगर ई इतना हुआ तो आ इतना होगा, तो र न न ते ता र न र न न रे न र न न ते ता र न र तो बोले ये स्थाई है, इसको भरो। अभी बोले विस्तार करते, रे ना, अभी सिंगल स्ट्रोक में करना, रे ना, अभी रे रा, दो स्ट्रोक हो गया, ना रे रा चिकारी, रे अभी चिकारी से ना बताया। तो इस तरह से उन्होंने बताया कि इसको ये करना है, इसको यू करना है, इसको यू करना है, विस्तार ऐसे होता है। फिर उसका कॉम्प्लेक्स फ्रेसेस बनाओ, उसके कंपाउंड फ्रेसेस बनाओ, तो ऐसे विस्तार बढ़ते 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 अलाप एक घंटे का सवा घंटे का हो जाता है। पहले वो करना ज़रूरी होता है कि अलाप आपका बहुत बड़ा हो जाए, उसके बाद फिर उसमें आप फिर उसका ऋषभ का स्थान कहाँ पर, जैसे ये गंधार लगेगी जो साधारण ही गंधार है, तीव्र मध्यम लगेगी जो चढ़ी भी है, तीव्र मध्यम डिमिने स्विफ्ट है, फिर प तो फिर उसके बाद स्वर स्थान को देखना है, उसके बाद देखना है उसकी टाइमिंग का हो रही है, उसकी कटिंग का हो रही है। तो ऐसे धीमे 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 करके एक एक क्लियर बनाते गया मैं, बहुत साल अभी भी मतलब उसमें हूँ कि और रिफाइन कैसे करना है और क्या करना है। सो दिस देन गॉट मी इनटू नाउ मोर मोड वेयर आई फील दैट अलाप इज एवरीथिंग फॉर द वीणा, इट्स गिविंग अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ लाइक सा का स्पेक्ट्रम है, यहाँ सा शुरुआत होता है, सा दो तीन, ये सा पांच छः, तो इसमें से कौन सा सा इस्तेमाल आ गई, अब ये सा ये फर्क है ना, चढ़ावासा है विहाग के लिए, चढ़ावासा है तोड़ी के लिए, क्योंकि उस क्यों ये मेरे अब समझ में आ गया कि ये क्यों हो रहा है, क्योंकि तानपुरे से ये पता चल रहा है कि इसका शड़ जहाँ उतरा हुआ है चढ़ा हुआ है वो क्यों हो रहा है, बिकॉज देयर इज अ टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस। ये जो टेम्परेचर सुबह जो होता है उसके बाद स्वर चढ़ जाते हैं, फिर वापस दोपहर में थोड़े उतर जाते हैं, फिर चढ़ जाते हैं, तो ये जो साइकिल चलता है और चारों मौसम में उनके अलग होते हैं, उसलिए आप मेघ समर में बजाते हो, मल्हार रेनी सीजन में बजाते हो, मेघ का जो मिनिएचर है आप देख रहे हो कि उसके अंदर क्लाउड्स है, देयर इज नो रेन, सो इट्स प्लेड इन द समर, मल्हार इज प्लेड इन द दिस थिंग, फॉर मी सारंग इज प्लेड इन द विंटर रेन्स, नॉट इन द समर रेन्स। आई हैव अ वेरी बिकॉज देयर इज अ थ्योरी अबाउट वार्म राग एंड कूल राग्स आल्सो, तो सारंग इज लाइक अ वार्म राग बट अ मल्हार इज लाइक अ कूल राग, तो वो उसमें से मतलब निकलता है। अभी अगर आप कुछ चीजें जैसे हम लोग पुरानी थॉट सिस्टम नहीं मानते, जो राग रागन राग रागनी पत्ती पत्ती
इन द दरबार साहब इन द गोल्डन टेंपल ट्रेडिशन फॉर एग्जांपल सारंग इज नॉट प्लेड ड्यूरिंग बसंत, इट इज फॉरबिडन। जब बसंत शुरू करते हैं
सारंग बंद होता है, बसंत जब पूरा मौसम खत्म होगा उसके बाद फिर सारंग शुरू करेंगे।
the ideology changes, how you want to, how you trying to perceive it, अगर आप राग रंजनी पद्धति पे बढ़ते हो तो फिर वो पूरा लक्ष्य बदल जाता है. फिर आप हर चीज पे ध्यान दोगे कि इसका षडज कहाँ गया, इसका निषाद कहाँ गया. इसलिए यू प्रिफर टू बी विद द आलाप एंड एक्सप्लोर विद द आलाप, क्योंकि हमको इतनी सारी पॉसिबिलिटीज दिखती है उसमें कि मेजॉरिटी, इफ यू हैव सीन माय कॉन्सर्ट्स, 90% 95% आई प्लेइंग आलाप टू ढला एंड देन आई एम जस्ट प्लेइंग सम पखावज एंड जस्ट लेटिंग इट गो. But this is a different way. This is the old, one of the old ways of looking at
fair enough.
The sadharan ki
gitiya. Absolutely. I mean, Ragnath to gitiya uski adaptation alag alag logo ne kiya, jaise tabiyat thi. But the idea of Ragnath, the way the Ragnath, rag is the way it is. It doesn't change. Application, preferences do change in a way. But I want to, you know, address briefly with the idea of compositions, because coming from, you know, being being an uncolonized Sikh and a Punjabi, the way knowledge was passed on in our system, in the Guru Nanak ki silsila, was a little different. Age was not considered, there was no guarantee of age. People lived, you know, they never knew when there's going to be a fight, for example, or when they're going to get persecuted. Be it from the times, you know, the Mughal times or later period, or the especially coming from the lines, bloodlines who never shook hands with the British. My ancestors were constantly in, you know, fight with them until they were thrown out eventually, or they so-called left in a glorified manner. It became difficult for them to sustain. But the idea, point is that knowledge was taught, was passed on from one generation to the other very quickly, in the sense that compositions were passed on like this because they didn't know when there would be the next chance. Whereas when I you know, look at some of the very luxurious ideas of you know, but you gave two narrations. One is your dad and then your uncle. But I would, you know, would also understand that because losing his elder brother, his godlike brother, would have been very traumatic for him. And you're talking about how he began talking afterwards, because he was introduced with the idea of life and coming and going in a very intimate manner. I think he never recovered, because I was very close also with your uncle. He was also my colleague in the Sangeet Nara Academy, and you know, for the executive elections, for the executive board, me and Chote Ustad were pitted against. We fought election against each other, and I won it, and I got into the election, into the executive board of the Sangeet Nara Academy. So that was the fun part, very intimate thought that I shared with you, because in the session General Council from 2009 to 2014, we were together in that. The idea of, you know, the passage of knowledge in our system is ke bandishen to kara do jaldi, jitna jaldi hoti hain.
Achha.
But sanskar bhi saath mein diya jata hai. Ye nahi ki badtameez bana gaya. Pehle, the first thing that was taught to me by Arjun Singh Tarangad is ke beta, I'm granting you the mehenga ilm. महंगा इल्म, बट बदतमीज मत बन जाना कि किसी की जाके हर एक की पगड़ी उखाड़ता रहे, पगड़ी उतारता रहे. सो दिस इज अ फर्स्ट सबक. ही सेज आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू नॉलेज विच इज रेयर, विच इज नॉट आउट देयर, एंड बट डू नॉट बिकम एरोगेंट, डू नॉट बिकम स्टूपिड, डू नॉट लूज योर मैनर्स. Do not become ill-mannered that you go on insulting others just because they don't have that which we are about to grant you or endow upon you. So there was an intizamat of how they would, because they knew, I don't know what's next, because they never shook hands with the British. That means they were living in caravans in the jungle. They never knew when they'll be faced, or with the Mughals, etc., etc., going back to Guru Gobind Singh times and so on and so forth. So this is very interesting for me to see where
some of the elders who somehow have a different take on the idea of life and death, but how they improvise. And then you are telling about your uncle, that you touch him one thing, ask him who won, and he's telling many, like, also the same experience by Arjun Singh Tarangar. If I would ask him, ke pita ji, a cheez kitna hundi hai, wo kehne ke betya, the question is good, but there are 10 things before and 5 things after. So let me tell you, let me start where the story begins. So that's how the you know, your interactions with Farid Saab remind me of my experience with Pai Arjun Singh Tarangad and my younger grand uncles Pai Avtar and Pai Gurcharan. So that I think was very interesting. But now take me back to the Murchana, because this is very intimate, and thank you for sharing. Manikol Bhai, of course, has been to this residence only. You watched me play the Taus when I had made it. Madan Gopal and others, I knew them and I knew him well because of that, because he was a big devotee of Guru Nanak. I mean, from the Kaul family and from the Kashmir, it was very close. He had a very intimate relationship with Guru Nanak. That was great for him, for you to share with your interactions with Mani Bhai. Take us to that, the Murchanas that your dad taught and that Kalyan. Can you pick up the Veena maybe and show us?
Just a simple.
The very first ones. Yeah, the very first ones.
In Bilawal. Nothing.
So this was in Bilawal when he began?
Well, can you get a charger for the computer? Laptop?
So it was in the Bilawal. My question. What my question was,
very simply,
my question, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Meri awaaz aa rahi hai?
Yeah.
Maine pucha, so did you mention Bilawal? It was the first rag that the Murshana was taught to you in Bilawal, is it?
Only in one rag. Bilawal mein hi bajana hai. For the first few years played in Bilawal.
That's interesting.
And then afterwards when it feel like in Bhairav.
In the Darbar Sahib Parampara, it's interesting. We begin with Asa or Bilawal. That's brilliant. Huh? Please continue.
So they said, he said ki har raag mein murchana nahi bajana hai, raag ka abhyas karna hai, it's on the other side, raag ka abhyas karna hai aur man se dimag mein karna hai aur murchana hai.
It's for, I think it's very, very important. Yeah, very important.
इस लय में करना है और उसको फिर अगर लय बढ़ानी है तो डबल, लेकिन एक लय ज्यादा देर तक काम करनी है और फिर
thank you.
कभार उन्होंने सुन लिया तो बोलते हैं हाँ जरा मूर्छना बजा के बताओ. इट्स वेरी स्ट्रेंज. देन आई सेड आई वुड प्ले फॉर 2 मिनट्स. बोले नहीं अब वो मूर्छना में बात पैदा नहीं हुई, उसको करते जाना है.
अच्छा.
वो बोलते थे मूर्छना आलाप की तरह गाने लगना चाहिए.
हाँ.
तब मैं मानूंगा कि उसमें बात पैदा हुई. इट्स वेरी स्ट्रेंज जस्ट बिकॉज टू और थ्री डेज अगो आई वॉज हैविंग अ कॉन्वर्सेशन विद वन ऑफ माई स्टूडेंट्स ऑनलाइन हु इज अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ समबडी हु लर्न फ्रॉम पंडित रविशंकर जी and in America, I forgot his name, I'm sorry, but he said my Guruji would go to learn from Pandit Ravi Shankar ji once in 6 months because he would be constantly touring and all that. And when he would come back, he said my Guruji had a whole lot of ideas about everything. And he said, he would say, ye raag mein, ye raag mein, ye raag mein. So Ravi Shankar ji would say ki, wo sab theek hai, murchana sunao tumhara. So I think Murchana was the key thing that we used to make.
Everybody.
And and it's something I cannot explain. Uske gun kya hai? Why it is so? I cannot explain. But when you do it for every person, it has something it gives which it will not give to somebody else. There is a uniqueness that creates in every person because of that. Because uske andar aap apna swabhav dalte hai. Because my father said, you're not playing music, you're not playing notes, you're not playing the raag, finally aap apka swabhav baja rahe hain. To wo swabhav aapko badalna padta hai, wo murchana mein usko swabhav aapko baithna chahiye. Jab wo swabhav usme baithega to aapka raag bolega. Tab tak bole kuch nahi. Because I had a very strange, this very veena, this is the second veena. And the first veena he used to always play. It was a chamber house, I remember. I came from outside and I saw my father playing the veena and mujhe chadh gaya. I mean, I was 11 or 12 or something, or 14 or something, I don't remember. He may be bajata hu because I had never seen him practice in my life. Never he picked up an instrument. Wo din unhone ko jawari bawari karte rehte the, apne jawari ki thoda wo usko baja rahe the, so tar ke uske upar marks aane chahiye, fir usko wapas ghisenge. So bajar rahe the, and he was playing his veena. And he was playing Yaman, you know, and I said, I will also play Yaman with him. So he just looked like this, you know. Dekhte the aise, acha. So kabad mein se I took out the veena and I sat in front of him. And this veena was in very bad condition. The strings were rusted, there was no jawari, there was no sound, nothing. Abhi to ye बहुत अच्छी बोलती हूँ, कुछ नहीं बोलती थी, इसके सब पर्दे द फ्रेट्स वर कट एंड ऑल दैट, यू नो. एंड देन ही स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग एंड आई स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग एंड आई सेड यू नो, आई सेड दिस ओल्ड मैन इज टेकिंग मी फॉर अ राइड. आई टेल यू, आई सेड ही हैज अ फैंटास्टिक इंस्ट्रूमेंट इन हिज हैंड एंड ही इज गिवन मी दिस थिंग इन माय हैंड व्हिच डजंट साउंड एनीथिंग. सो आई सेड हाउ डू आई आस्क हिम. सो आई सेड पापा जी, आई सेड टेक मी. When he looked at me, he understood what is the next thing because he was my father, you know. And I said, "Main dekhna chah raha hu aapki veena kaise bolti hai." Bole dekhna chah raha hai. I said, "Ha ha." So I took his veena, you know, and I said, "Aap tab tak ye bajaiye." So he said, "Ha, theek hai." He smirked little bit. I didn't understand that he understood, and I took that veena. And he took this veena, and this veena sounded exactly the same way that the other veena was sounding. And that veena sounded exactly the same way that I was playing, no matter what I did. After 5 minutes, I realized there is something, you know, not right over here. I mean, this is something else. So I kept the veena and acted like nothing happened, and you know, very pious face. And I said, "Ha, acha hai." So he looked at me like this. हो गया? ऐसे हाँ हो गया. ऐसे बोले बेटा मैं तेरा बाप हूँ. वीणा बजाने के लिए बहुत मेहनत करनी पड़ती. वीणा बदलने से वीणा बजाने में नहीं आती.
बिल्कुल.
So I came back that veena. I took this veena. I put it inside and I went out quietly. It was like a proper chamata, but a very nice one in a very loving manner.
Yeah.
And then I realized it's not like this. It's you have to. He told me, he said, you can be born in a musician family, you can put my blood into your blood, you can have a blood transfusion, बट सरस्वती जो कहे सो उसकी विद्या है, विल हैव टू सिट एंड डू इट. इफ यू थिंक दैट यू आर बॉर्न टू सम म्यूजिशियन एंड यू विल बी एबल टू डू इट, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू हैपन. यू हैव टू कमिट योर सेल्फ एंड वॉट इज योर इंटेंशन दैट विल फाइनली डिसाइड हाउ यू वॉन्ट टू डू दिस. आई मीन most of our lessons were talks like this. Kabhi ye bata diya, बोले इस तरह से दोनों मध्यम लगती, बोले अल्पत्व है विहाग में, दो मिनट करके छोड़ देता. हाँ अच्छा तुम्हारा स्कूल का क्या हो गया? आई एम लाइक नो, बट दे वुड स्टे इन योर माइंड. ही वुड वेट विद द स्टूडेंट, ही वुड वेट टू सी, बिकॉज देयर वाज बी अ टाइम विद द स्टूडेंट विद द विंडो इज ओपन इन द माइंड. That time he would quickly put in something and then move away. And he would do that a lot. Another incident I remember is once I came from outside. This was when I was not learning. And I went into the music room. And before that I had my bath, changed my clothes. And my father was sitting outside reading a newspaper in the evening. And I said, "Main abhi Yaman bajane wala hun." So my father said, "Achha, achha, bajao, bajao. वो कौन से वीणा पे बजाओगे?" अच्छा आपके वीणा पे बजाऊंगा. ठीक है बजाओ. सो बोला आप सुनिएगा मुझे बताइएगा बाद में. इसे हाँ बिल्कुल सुनूंगा मैं बताइए. सो आई स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग. यू प्ले एट दैट एज यू प्ले अ वेरी बोरिंग यमन. आई प्लेड एंड आफ्टर 10 मिनट्स इसे बाहर बहुत आवाज़ आ रहा है, तुमको डिस्टर्ब नहीं होना चाहिए कि मैं दरवाज़ा बंद करता हूँ. सो वी जस्ट हैड टू रूम्स, आउटसाइड रूम इनसाइड रूम. ठीक है अच्छा हाँ ठीक है. He closed the door and I played Yaman, Alap, Jod, Jalap. 20 minutes flat, everything was over. But my joy, I have played Yaman. And I came outside, opened the door, and I looked here, I looked there, and then the other room went into the kitchen. And I said, "Ai, Papa." He says,
"Hello."
He closed the door and he
Hello.
Went to the market.
We lost you for a second. So when you spoke with I, we lost you from there.
Yeah. He said, I said, "I, Papa Kute, where is my father?" He said, "He went to the market." I said, "When did you go to the market?" He said, "When you closed the door, he went to the market." I said, "What is this man? I asked him to listen to what I'm playing and he's gone to the market. How will I learn?" And after half an hour, he came back. The moment I opened the door, he said, "Just take this vegetables, put it, give it to your mother and all that. Sit down." I said, "He said, you played?" He said, "Yeah." He said, "When you went from the Madhyam to the Pancham and to the Dhaivat, you see, you applied too much Dhaivat. You shouldn't do that." And I had done that. And I said, "What?" He said, "Haan, tumne Dhaivat bahut hi jyada laga di. Wo vikrit ho gaya wahan par raha. Utni Dhaivat nahi lagate usme." अच्छा आप तो मार्केट गए थे, आपको कैसे पता चला? बोले बेटा पाल बच्चे के लक्षण पालने में दिखते हैं, पोत के लक्षण पालने में दिखते हैं. बोले जैसे तूने शुरुआत किया था ना, मुझे पता था तू तो वैसी दही बत लगाया. तो लगाए कि नहीं लगाई? लहा लगाया. बोले जी आप जान. आई मीन दीज गाइज वर आई मीन इंटेलिजेंट इन द सेंस, आई मीन दे न्यू एग्जैक्टली वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू डू नेक्स्ट. इसी रूम में एक बार आई रिमेम्बर नैन्सी वॉज लर्निंग. And she was, because Manipal wanted her to do Shri in that film of her, that Kashmir film. And she had learned it for 3 months and something. And then after that she said, "Ustad, I would like to learn this even more, you know. I want to do the Shri." And said, "Okay, let's do it." So after a few months, I was just sitting right over here. And my father was sitting over here. He used to wear his banyan and lungi. And I came and sat. And she began. उन्होंने बोला बोली लिखनी जब ऊपर निशान में जाएगी ना तभी जाके अटकेगी. आफ्टर 45 मिनट्स शी वेंट इनटू द निशान अपर सप्तक अंदरे के लिए. एंड शी सेड उस्ताद व्हाट डू आई डू ओवर हियर. उन्होंने बोला ना, बोला आपको कैसे पता चला? बोले बेटा ये मालूम पड़ता है, ध्यान रखो. शुरुआत कैसी होगी उसका अंत क्या है ये तो पता चलता है. ये स्वभाव है इंसान का, वो कहाँ जाके अटकेगा. So I mean, these kind of teachings we had was very एटीट्यूड एंड वेरी यू नो एलिवेटिंग इन अ मैनर कि वो बोलते थे कि ये मुझे याद है एक बार मैंने पूछा अभोगी कैसा है तो बता देंगे ये बता देंगे मैं 8 महीने निकल गए. एक दिन मैंने वो इस चेंबर के घर में मैंने बोला उनके हाथ में वीणा देखी फिर मैंने बोला ये मौका अच्छा है पूछते अभोगी कैसा है तो मैंने पूछा बोला पापा पापा हाँ अभोगी कैसा है तो फिर यूं करके देखा उन्हें धैवत पर रख के सीधा उसकी गंधार खींचे अभोगी की यहाँ तक एकदम एकदम बहुत ही बेसुरी सी गंधार लगाई उतरी भी एकदम बोले ये गंधार सुन रहे हो हाँ गा के बता तो मैंने कोशिश की एक दो बार दो तीन दफा गलत हुई उतारो उतारो हाँ ये थोड़ा चढ़ाओ हाँ यहाँ पर अब मैं लगाता हूँ बोलना वही है बोले हाँ अब तू गा के बता हाँ अब थोड़ा उतार अब मैं लगाता वही है हाँ ये गंधार हाँ अब तू लगा हाँ अब ठीक है अब मैं देखो मैं वही लगा रहा हूँ ये 5 मिनट तक चला उसके बाद जिस दिन तेरे को गंधार समझ में आएगी ना उस दिन तेरे को अभोगी आ जाएगा. और वो मैंने बोला ये क्या है ये क्या होता है मैंने कहा भोगी धस आएगा कैसे जाऊंगा बोले जिस दिन गंधार. और सच कह रहा हूँ बलदीप जी एक दिन मेरे ऐसे बैठे बैठे वो गंधार समझ में आ गई और पूरा अभोगी ऐसे दिखा मुझे वो मेरे बजा के उस कान में बोला ये इनका सिखाने का तरीका इनका सिखाने का हाँ इट्स वेरी और वेरी कैजुअल कि ऐसे सिखा रहे जैसे हम फॉर्मल लेसन ले रहे हैं कोई आके बैठ रहा है नहीं. इवन पुष्पराज जी के साथ जब मैंने देखा कि वो पुष्पराज जी आया उनका एक टाइम था 7:05 पे एंटर करते घर पे ट्रेन पर से उतरते थे 7:05 को घंटी बजती थी चाय पी के 7:30 बजे दोनों अंदर दरवाजा बंद सितार मिला के पुष्पराज जी अपने यमन ही मिलाते थे फिर उसको रखते थे और फिर थोड़े देर बचता था और 2-3 घंटे बातें होती थी. तो ये मतलब उनका ऐसा था कि वो सीखते समय सीखने वाले को प्रेशर नहीं होना चाहिए कि मैं सिखा रहा हूँ या मैं कुछ सीख रहा हूँ उसको बात समझा दी हाँ थोड़ा बजा के बताओ बेटा हॉस्पिटल हाँ हाँ अब रख दो ठीक है. और फिर इसकी बात वो बात ये बात वो बात ऑन दिस वन डे समी आज सोच पुष्पराज की तुम्हारे गुरु जी बातें तो बहुत करते हैं सिखाते कुछ नहीं है तो बोले बोले उनकी बातें ही सुनो तो सबको समझ में आएगा कि वो क्या सिखा रहे हैं क्या कह रहे हैं. तो इट वॉज अ वेरी डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट जैसे आप बोल रहे थे कि गुरु जी सब सिखा रहे हैं ये एक तरीका था कि कॉम्पोजिशन सिखा रहे हैं ये सिखा रहे हैं वो सिखा रहे हैं ये कर रहे हैं और ये एक दूसरा तरीका था कि एक बीज दे दिया अब तुम उसको बो उसको दूर से बैठ के बोलो अभी पानी डाल अभी थोड़ा खाद डाल अभी थोड़ा उसको जमीन को थोड़ा ढीला कर हाँ अब देखते थोड़ा उसको जरा सूरज की तरफ रखना अब वो पॉट में से थोड़ा बड़ा हो गया उसको उस पर लगा देना दूर से वो डायरेक्ट करते थे क्योंकि आदमी को खुद लगता था कि वो खुद कर रहा है. He's not learning, but he would feel like he's able to walk. It's like a child feeling that you're able to walk. Someone is holding your hand, but the child feels I'm walking. It's like he's driving a cycle. चार पहिए हैं उसमें, दो पहिए पीछे ऐसे extend है और पीछे से बाप भी फिर भी ऐसे पकड़ के माँ पकड़ के उसको धक्का लगा रही है. लेकिन बच्चे को लग रहा है कि हम चला रहे हैं. ये वो student के अंदर डालते थे, जिससे उसको लगता था कि हाँ हम कुछ कर सकते हैं. So as a result, every student would have felt at the end. Fine, I can do something in life with this, whatever little or big. He used to always say, well, two things used to say, कि गुरु कोई बड़ा छोटा नहीं होता. अपने श्रद्धा से गुरु को मानो छोटा गुरु, छोटा गुरु भी बहुत बड़ा हो जाता है. और बोले ये मत देखो कि वो क्या कर रहा है, तुम ऐसे करो कि वो तुम्हारा अपना उसमें आ जाए कि वो नहीं कर पाएगा. This is बोली वही चीज है. एंड थर्ड थिंग इज ऑलवेज सेड कि संगीत जो है ये सुख भोगने का सामग्र है. आई विल टीच यू हाउ टू एंजॉय इट, यू विल हैव टू एंजॉय इट. आई कैन टेक द हॉर्स टू द वॉटर बट आई कैन नॉट मेक हिम ड्रिंक द वॉटर. आई कैन शो यू. गुरु जो होता है बोले मार्गदर्शक होता है, वो आपको बताएगा क्या करना है और आपको वो करना, अगर नहीं करो तो कुछ नहीं होने वाला. गुरु का कुछ नहीं बिगड़ेगा, आपका बिगड़ेगा.
The there are two aspects where, as I said, the idea of time in the we're looking at two kinds of pedagogies, or actually two aspects of the pedagogy. One is when you have time, what happens? How do you deal with time? The subtleties when you are zooming in into different aspects. The other is a passage of knowledge or treasure
before time comes calling, like the door gets shut before the age or time, yeah. Time comes calling. So usme in the parampara, in the Gurbani, the Darbar Sahib tradition is called milat. Is called process of ke milat pani, milat ko hasil karna. When he was saying ke gandhar de, gandhar de. So way I'm seeing it is that's the process of gaining milat. Ke meri gandhar aur tumhari gandhar mil jaye, milat ho jaye. But that is what we call iteration and reiteration. Yani ki usko bar bar dohrana sabak ko. Usme pehle body aa gaya, then you go into the subtlety ke cheez aa gayi. For example, when we were looking at some of the texts, you know, when they die, when the Nad dies, I was looking at the seven compositions, for example, in from the Guru Granth. There's a combination of the seven pratals. Or they're not pratals, sorry. The padas, very unique padas. आसा में पहले चलता है कि गोबिंद गोबिंद करी हाँ हरि हरि मन प्यार हाँ गुर कहे आसो चिति धरी हाँ अनस्यो तोर फेरी हाँ ऐसे लालन पायो री सकी. दिस इज द अस्थाई. पंकज मोह सरी हाँ पग नहीं चला हरि हाँ गहड्यो मूड़ नरी हाँ अनन उपाव करी हाँ तो निकसे सरन पैरी सकी. थिर थिर चित थिर हाँ बनु ग्रह समसरी हाँ अंतरी एक पिर हाँ बाहर अनेक धरी हाँ राजन जोग करी हाँ कहो नानक लोग अलोगी री सकी. ये उसका दुपदा, ये दुपदा है. जैसे ध्रुपद तो बाद में टर्म पड़ा, पहले एक पदा दो पदा त्रिपदा चौपदा पंचपदा अष्टपदा, ये पदे पदों का गाना था. पर इसके बाद फिर आसा के बाद आसावरी का चलता है चलन. अगले जो छह पदे हैं कि मनसा एक मानी हाँ गुरस्यो नेत ध्यान हाँ दृढ़ संत मंत ज्ञान हाँ सेवा गुर चरानी हाँ तो मिली है गुर कृपानी मेरे बना. पुराने सुना रहा हूँ, ये अस्थाई है. फिर अगला है हरि 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 गुनी हाँ जपिय सहज धुनी हाँ साधु रसन भनी हाँ छूटन भिधि सुनी हाँ पाइय वड पुनी मेरे मना. दिस इज द अस्थाई ऑफ द यू नो नेक्स्ट पदा, द थर्ड वन. देन देर इज द फोर्थ वन, उसका असावरी में एका ओट गहो हाँ गुर का शब्द कहो हाँ आज्ञा सती सहो हाँ मन ही निधान लहो हाँ सुख समाई है मेरे मना. ये स्थाई है, इसके भी दो पदा है. और फिर इसका अगला दो पदा है मिली हर जस गाई है हाँ परम पद पाई है हाँ उआ रस जो भिधे हाँ तो ताको सगल सिद्धे हाँ अनदिनो जाग्या हाँ नानक बड़ भाग्या मेरे मना. ये स्थाई है, इसके बाद फिर इसके दो पदे हैं. फिर अगला जो पांचवा छठा पदा है कारण करण तू हाँ अवर न सूझ है मुँह हाँ कर ही सो होइय हाँ सहज सुखी सोइय हाँ धीरज मनी भय हाँ प्रभ कै दरी पए मेरे मना. इज द अस्थाई ऑफ द सिक्स्थ पदा. नाउ द सेवेंथ वन इज एक तो का दो पदा आ सातवीं है. The point I'm making is, I've you know, for the book that I'm writing for the अपने सेमिनार के लिए मैं I'm writing the paper where I gave the keynote address. So इसका धमार है, पंजाबी धमार है, ताधन कड़धन धन धागे त्रकड़धागे तीन कड़तिन तिन ऐसे चलता है. पॉइंट आई एम मेकिंग इसके जो पहले छह का सात का एक गुच्छा है जिसमें हर छंद जो है ओए परदेसिया हाँ सुनत संदेसिया हाँ ये अस्थाई है. फिर जहां से रची रहे हाँ एटसेट्रा एट्स हाँ 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 आ रहा है, सात है. इसमें से मेरे पास out of the thousands of compositions in Guru Granth, only the seventh pada I have received. Now there is no way until I had received the intangible knowledge of, यानी कि जो सूक्ष्म भेद है पदे का कि इसको गाया कैसे जाता था, वो नहीं पाते हैं. So that's one aspect of time, how heritage was survived or saved, and before time comes, when before time's up for me, how do I put it across to the next generation? How can this knowledge remain? That was one. And the other aspect which you've so beautifully shared is the process of reiteration and iteration until you gain the milit. कि अब वो zero in होता है कि इसका स्वर कैसे है, इसकी श्रुति क्या है, कि बिहाग कैसे बना, या तुखारी कैसे बना, या गौड़ी कैसे बनी, गौड़ी बैरागन कैसे हुई, गौड़ी पूरिया कैसे हुई, वगैरह वगैरह. So I think these are very, very two aspects for those who are listening, the students especially, so that they are able to understand the two aspects that we are both emphasizing. I thought that I'll share that with you. The problems that there are. Achha, Sunanda ki farmaish hai ki Bhim Palasi sunna cha rahi hai. Ab mujhe malum nahi ki tum usko sunana chahte ho Bhim Palasi ke nahi. अगर मिजाज है, अगर दया आ रही है,
को घर पे सुनाऊं, अब समय कहाँ है, भीमपलास कहाँ
है? सुनंदा सुन लो, है? या तो अब घड़ी पीछे करके बताते तो कर देते कि घड़ी पीछे कर देते तो समय की.
सुनंदा जी आपको घर पे आके सुना लूंगा भीमपलास.
ठीक है. अच्छा, to come back to the idea of instrument, कि ये जो instrument, the one that you have in your hands, is not the, it's quite close to the playing, the mudra is quite close to the Saraswati Veena. But the original one that your dad, of course, used to play was the more conventional Rudrabeen, the way, or the Veen, that was Rudrabeen used to be the Dhurpadi Rabab, the term which got associated with the Veen later. This was the Veen Bajana jo kandhe pe rakke tha. So now with the advent of technology, when he was trying to find solutions of being audible, he had to do everything. That he was an innovator, he was a creator, he was an ideator, he was a thinker, and he tried to find solutions which are technical, which are mechanical, which had to do with luthiri and so on and so forth. String ka size kaise hoga? He went a little notes, a few notes lower, but the strings were tighter so that they could be sort of heard across. The microphone even could catch at that time. Now with the advent of technology, do you feel that you can go back to the original form of the Veena with the kind of arrangements that there are, or you would be more intention, your intimacy is more with the instrument that your father eventually ended up creating, but this is not that Veena as such, it is a change as such, and the other instrument, as a conservator I'm talking, instruments die. Yes, new things are formed, but the old things which have sustained for hundreds and hundreds of years, or thousands of years, and sometimes those things die a death. For example, Sarod's advent came, but the Dhurpadi Rabab died. So people at times, when their own necessity of the day, traditions or legacies have also gone and become extinct. What do you think about the advent of technology, the lack of technology thereof during your dad's innovative years? He had to play with the handicap that he had. He had to play, make modifications so that what he was doing could be even heard, what was happening, what the instrument was listening to itself, you know, people. And he made the adaptations and created and made innovations. How do you see both these aspects?
Well, I think that the changes he made was not because of, because he wanted it to be heard, because he had a certain vision of a sound and how it should sound. वो बोलते थे जब नीचे खरज में जाते हैं तो गाने के साथ बोले वीणा की खरज फीकी पड़ती है, तो मुझे उसके लिए ऐसी एक बेस वाली खरज चाहिए, साउंड लाइक द सिंह गर्जना, तो लाइक द इट साउंड लाइक अंडर वाटर ड्रैगन. सो फॉर दैट ही पुट चेंज द काइंड ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग्स एंड द जवारी एंड फ्रॉम केम इन टू टीक वुड एंड ऑल दिस थिंग्स. I think that time technology in a way was simpler, in a way was much better, because you had not too many things to fiddle with. you had those bulb pre-amplifiers which could carry a huge, in the hertz thing, parrot would capture quite a bit. The only thing was you required a pre-amplifier which was really powerful. Like for the Veena, you require a pre-amplifier which should be at least about 3000 to 5000 watts or at least 2000 RM, that RMPS or I think you call it. So that was not available. Today, I think we have quite a few other things. Like I'm putting all this through a 664 sound devices. I'm using a 4:1 to talk. Now, over here, I'm using a Shoaib's MQ4, but otherwise I use the Earthworks, which they use SR30, which they use in the concerts. The whole thing about technology is that you can become a slave to it. You have to know what your boundaries are and how much do you require, because it gives you too much, what volume you want to play it in. So I would use a contact mic now where I see there is no possibility of a preamp or amp in an auto hall in India. It's been powerful, so I would use a preamp. Or if you play something at 10,000 people, then you have to use a contact microphone. Otherwise, I'm going back to using just the Earthworks, one front and one behind, keeping the volume low. And but basically what one is doing here is not adapting to the technology, but making that technology adapt to what you want to say. I mean, what you want to do and how you want to say has to be the basis of everything, and the technology has to be on the periphery. In that way, I would say that he has not changed the Veena to adapt to adapt to the newer technology or the way it is to be heard. But it was just a different sound, and what he required as sound for his alap in Dhrupad. That was within his mind, and he crafted that with Nitai Babu Kanhai Lal in 1963, the very first Veena.
But there was another...
If you go to technology, तो आपका टोनल क्वालिटी बदलता है. टोनल क्वालिटी अगर आपकी बदल गई तो आपका व्हाट यू वांट टू से आल्सो चेंजेस. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू कीप अ सर्टेन पिक्चर इन माइंड अबाउट व्हाट टोनल क्वालिटी यू वांट एंड व्हाट आर यू गोइंग टू कन्वे थ्रू दैट टोनल क्वालिटी एंड दैट शुड नॉट चेंज. But because I can use a reverb, I can use something else, and then it can finish, it becomes
something else. The idea is to amplify the sound of the instrument, not to modulate or modify the sound of the instrument. That's two different aspects.
No, exactly. Just to amplify.
Yeah, exactly. And the other aspect is, but again, talking of innovations, I mean, when you either you use create changes by way of technology, or you create changes in the instrument by way of innovation. So if it is a change, it is a change. Yeah. The other aspect is that
this Veena is not very new. See, there's something called the Matangi Veena, which already exists, which is from Matangi Veena has come this idea. So it's not a new idea at all. All this, the Vasuki and all is 1200 ya 1300 shatabdi ki text mein ye sab likha hai, ye sab varnan. Yahan haathi honi chahiye kyunki this is the door to the heaven. Yahan par पर्दों की हाइट कितनी होनी चाहिए, यहाँ पर उंगली का ये कितना स्पेसिंग होना चाहिए, दो तुम्बे के बीच में कितना जगह होना चाहिए, और ऐसा भी शास्त्र में कहीं नहीं लिखा है कि कंधे के ऊपर ही वीणा होना चाहिए. ऐसा लिखा है कि कंधे की स्थिति में उसका तुम्बा होना चाहिए. तो एक्चुअली ही हैज नॉट चेंज्ड एनीथिंग, बट ही जस्ट रिवाइव्ड अ ओल्डर आइडिया विच ही अंडरस्टूड, विच मैच टू द वे व्हाट ही matched the way in which he was thinking about his music, and those two he put together.
But it was also became heavy, you know, the way the innovations he made a very instrument heavy, and it was not possible to hold it across. So those are
from 3 kilos it went to 10 kilos.
Exactly. Yeah. So that was not easy. Yeah, so
now normally playing on the shoulder is like you won't lose your shoulder in a few days.
Exactly.
So it's just
or you have to become a wrestler. you're a wrestler with the instrument.
No, still it's not possible. Yeah. I mean, if you're struggling that much just to keep it that, then it's not.
It is more than exactly. That is one.
Yeah.
The other is that the singing also became lower.
Originally, it used to be from the Gandha. So the Veena, as it was okay for the range, the vocal range that used to be before. So is that is in fact led to the change, modification of the instrument? That's one. Secondly, is it also that because he was an outstanding sitar player, was he also wanting to bring some of the aspects that sitar could do and the Veena could not do?
No. Because I think in terms of possibilities, the Veena has much more power.
Exactly. Yeah. But in terms of slides, etc., because Sitar was undergoing a change Sitar at the same time in the 50s when the dand was shifted. Yeah. And your dad is in the middle of everything, all the innovations that are happening, he's witnessing them. So that is the time when the modification of the Veena is happening by him in the same.
But his picture was very clear that he wants to focus on the arab, not to focus on the tayari. So what to do to bring in that alarm into the instrument? It was not that the old beans were not capable of this. They were capable of this, but there was certain tonal quality which went with his nature. And he says, I want to do this. This is what I want. Because necessity is the mother of all inventions. You cannot invent and say, this is necessary. It's not possible. The vice versa is just not possible. So he had thought about ki ye giti ki gaiki ye ये अगर इसको फॉलो करना है तो इसमें स्ट्रोक्स कितने लगने हैं, आस कितनी होनी चाहिए, इसका आवाज़ कैसे रुकना है, इसका रुखाव कैसे होना चाहिए, तो ये किसके साथ बजा सकते हैं, ये कैसे लगेगा. सो ऑल दैट ही हैड इन माइंड एंड व्हाट इट वुड नॉट चेंज विद इन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फ्रेमवर्क एंड व्हाट इट वुड चेंज विच वॉज वेरी लिटिल एंड देन ही पुट इट टू प्ले बिकॉज द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ द विनर शुड नॉट गेट लॉस्ट वॉज द फर्स्ट थिंग. द सेकेंड थिंग इज कि द गायकी शुड नॉट बी टैम्पर्ड विद. बिकॉज आप सितार में बार बार स्ट्रोक लगाते हो, इसमें एक स्ट्रोक आपने किया था, इसमें जैसे अगर आपने सुर सिंगार बजाया हो तो उसका आस देखिए कितना है, वो डी में मिलता है. कोई अकंपनिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट वोकलिस्ट के साथ अब उसको आप बजा के देखिए तो बराबर उस गायकी के साथ उसकी मिलती है. तो वो चाह रहे थे कि ये गाने के साथ मिलना चाहिए. That's why he worked on all this. कि decoration कितना होना चाहिए, नहीं होना चाहिए, ये कितना करने से लकड़ी खाएगा, कितना करने से नहीं खाएगा, फिर frets की height कितनी होगी तो खींचने में और घर्षण में सही होना चाहिए, फिर यहाँ अगर जगह है तो अब घर ऐसा का अपने को यहाँ मूवमेंट मिलेगा. तो those things, ब्रिज की हाइट रहनी चाहिए, उसकी जवारी की उन्होंने स्टडीड विथ Hiran Roy and Kanhai Lal, how to do the jawari. फिर वीणा की जवारी कैसी करनी है, उसमें क्या है, क्योंकि खरच का तार बहुत मुश्किल से बैठता है तो उसको कैसे बैठाना है, फिर उसका टोन क्या होना चाहिए. उनका तो इतना था कि जवारी में कि तानपुरा में अगर वो खरच है बोले वो पूछते पहले पूछते थे इसमें से तुमको ओवरटोन कोमल निषाद की चाहिए या गंधार की चाहिए. कोई बोलता था कोमल निषाद की तो वो ऐसे करके थे वो नहीं ले लो कोमल निषाद, बोले आप फिर से गंधार करिए तो ऐसे एक हाथ मरते बोले दो गंधार आ गई. तो उनका वो इंटरेस्ट था, इट वाज ही वाज ग्रेटली इंटरेस्टेड इन दिस थिंग, यू नो हाउ अ थिंग यू कैन ब्रेक इट अप एंड हाउ यू कैन पुट इट टुगेदर. ही हैड अ जावा मोटरसाइकिल व्हेन ही वाज यंग एंड ही कुड पुट दैट जावा मोटरसाइकिल पीस बाय पीस अपार्ट टोटली एंड देन पुट इट बैक टुगेदर अगेन. सो ये उनका एक शौक था, इनोवेशन था. और उन्होंने कहा भी कि बचपन में मैंने बहुत सारी बीन बिगाड़ी, ताऊ जी की जो वीणा थी, बोले और बोले बहुत मैंने उसके लिए बहुत गालियां भी खाई, बहुत डांटी खाई मैंने उसके लिए, बोले फिर स्टिल आई टू कंटिन्यू टू डू इट. देन वन डे माय फादर टोल्ड कि तू जो खोज रहा है ना वो शास्त्र में वो लिखा है, वो मतंगी वीणा से आती है, वहां पढ़ लेना, फिर जो तुझे करना है तू करना, तुझे क्या चाहिए. तो उन्होंने बोला मुझे ऐसा चाहिए, बोले तो एक बार वो पढ़ना फिर अपना और उसके पहले अपना अभ्यास को क्लियर करना म्यूजिक का, फिर वो जाके उसके ऊपर बैठेगी, सिर्फ इन्वेंशन करने से नहीं होगा.
डू यू हैव योर ग्रैंडफादर्स वीणा, एनी ऑफ द ग्रैंड उस्ताद जियाउद्दीन खान्स?
नो, नथिंग इज देयर, वी डोंट हैव
रियली.
क्योंकि वो जब व्हेन ही लेफ्ट उदयपुर, व्हेन ही लेफ्ट उदयपुर ही लेफ्ट माय फादर लेफ्ट द हाउस विद व्हाटएवर क्लोथ्स ही वाज वेयरिंग. He didn't carry anything with him.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he left. वो घर छोड़के निकल गए. और there was some incident that happened. I also don't exactly remember now. And then he came from the palace. He came home. and he told my mother, my grandmother, ki main ja raha hu. So my grandmother told him, theek hai, ja rahe ho, to zindagi mein kuch chale jana, matlab, aur agar wapis aana hai to kuch ban ke aana, warna main ye manungi ki tu tha hi nahi, mere aur teen bacche hain. So this was the kind of thing, you know, she had told him. And then he left from there. From there he went to Delhi, he went to Calcutta. And then he finally came to Bombay and he thought that Bombay is a good place to work in. Mm-hmm. This working community and people, all kinds of different people. It's like cauldron. You just put on things, assimilating and mixing and new things happening. Mm-hmm. And he said, this is a good place to stay and do my work because no one will disturb me over here on what I want to do.
I see. But the instruments, who else then stayed on in Udaipur?
So for some time, my uncle Faridurin Dagar said stayed on. Then there was one younger brother of his, Saifuddin and Shafuddin. The two brothers were there. So they stayed in. One has passed away, one is still there. But they did not do music. Though it was in the blood, they chose not to do the music.
I see.
And my father, then he called Ustad from Udaipur and they both stayed in Bombay and then they did their work. They started playing here and there, teaching, playing in the film industry. They had nothing in the beginning when they came, they had nothing. They had no place to stay. वो हजी अली की दरगाह पे दिन भर बैठे रहते थे, माहिम की दरगाह के बाहर पीछे जाके सो जाते थे, फिर सुबह उठ के माहिम की चौपाटी पर खर्च का रियाज करते थे. तो वो सब उन्होंने किया है. दे वेंट थ्रू अ लॉट. फिर कैसे करते करते जब ये वीणा बनी तो इट बिकेम अ बिग इश्यू. पीपल वर सेइंग लाइक ये फर्नीचर अच्छा बना है डाकर साहब, बजना भी चाहिए, सुंदर दिखती है, आप वीणा बजाएंगे भूखे मरेंगे, सितार बजाइए आप. तो फादर से नहीं हो तो मैं शौक से बजाता हूँ, मुझे ऐसे शौक करके शौक में बजाना है ये. तो ऐसे ही इज टू लाइक जस्ट, बट ही वॉन्टेड टू, बिकॉज बोथ द ब्रदर्स इज टू प्ले सितार अर्लियर. And one incident, they played sitar whole night, and for which they got no money. So then my father said, you know, Farid, this has no respect, what we are doing with all our hearts. Main ye band kar raha hu, because people know that I am not a sitar player. But I like to play sitar, and I listened to some ustad and choti ustad playing at times, amazing sitar players. तैयारी वैयारी सब कुछ था. देन दे लेफ्ट इट. इसे नहीं बोले, इसमें कुछ नहीं है क्योंकि हमको कोई नहीं मारेगा, तू गाना और मैं वीणा बजाता हूँ.
आई सी.
दैट्स, और उसके पैरेलल उनके गाने की रियाज तो चालू ही थी.
तो
सिद्धार्थ तो मतलब ऐसे ही दाल रोटी के लिए करते थे वो. सो देन दे बोथ डिसाइडेड कि दिस इज व्हाट वी विल डू. पीपल लाइक इट और डोंट लाइक इट, दिस इज व्हाट वी वांट टू डू इन आवर लाइव्स.
व्हिच ईयर वाज द चेंज, दिस डिसीजन व्हेन दे मेड, व्हिच ईयर वाज दैट? डू यू रिकॉल द ईयर? Video, dad or uncle?
I think in 1959 he said. 1959,
60
we decided to do this.
I see.
Something. 59 or.
Are there some of the recordings of your dad and your uncle playing the sitar? Are there any recordings? Anybody recorded the old times?
I think Jeff has some. Jeff Lewis has some recordings of the sitar.
I see.
And then there was somebody who had a sitar. Recording of my uncle playing Rakesh Lee or something.
Oh really? I would love to hear that. Yeah.
I don't have it. I have to get it. I'll get it. Let's see.
Yeah. Let's. We should both get it.
Because they never allowed us to listen to those recordings.
I know.
He said, "Bali, this not Well, lot of recordings. And then they said, "Bali, de do sunna mat." Ne bola kyu? Bole, isse kuch nahi hoga. Itna hi reh jayega. Main jo baja raha hu samne, usko sunna.
Yeah.
Which made a lot of sense. वो किसी को रिकॉर्ड नहीं करने देते थे, बोले क्या तू रिकॉर्ड सुनेगा, मैं बजा रहा हूँ, मैं when I'm here, be present here.
Yeah.
I'm giving you something much more than a recording. इसे भूल जाऊँगा तो मतलब भूल जाएगा, तो जब समय आएगा तब याद आएगा तेरे को. So.
और to go back to the.
कभी-कभी रिकॉर्ड करने अलाउ करते.
हाँ. To go back to the Udaipur scene for a moment. So the ones who stayed back are still there.
One uncle has passed away, one is there.
But the instruments of your grandfather and other books, etc., nothing
no,
is
I
there?
Mean, see, there was no, nothing is there, because after independence, there was nothing at home. So my grandmother used a barter system of exchanging things. सो उनकी वीणा और किसी के पास रह गई थी तो वही रह गई थी, वो खत्म हो गई। फिर उनकी लकड़ी वकड़ी थी जो नवरत्न से जड़ित थी, वो फिर बेच के ये करके रिटर्न ये लेना वो लेना वो सब हो रहा था। इट वॉज अ डिफिकल्ट टाइम, इट वॉज टाइम।
No, but I was actually slowly leading up to the question that I was very intimate for me. So you're playing an instrument that, of course, is something that is innovated and created by your dad. Do you feel sometimes you want to also play the instrument like the one that was played by your grandpa, Ustad Ziauddin Khan?
Yeah, so the bachpan ki ek deen hai that I have played in Money Calls movie. When I was 10 years old, so I do like to play that instrument at times, and I like the other bean also because it has a very different, beautiful flavor.
I see.
You can't take something out of it.
Is it there with you here? Is it here at all?
It's gone for repair to nine because the bamboo got bent. I'm trying to.
Oh, I see. Straight. I see.
It's very old. It's when he was 16 years old.
Uh-huh. I see.
उनको महाराणा ने उनको वो दी थी, उसके तुम्बे नहीं है लेकिन दो दांड है तो उसमें दो तुम्बे लगा के मैं थोड़ा बजा था। वो मांकल इज टू टेल मी फरीदुद्दीन डाकर साहब की बोले ये वीणा उनके ऊपर ऐसे हंगी इसमें भी टंगी रहती थी उनकी, इसमें हैंग ऑन हिम ऑल द टाइम।
अच्छा।
एंड इज टू वॉक अराउंड देन व्हेन ही वांट्स टू प्ले इज टू प्ले एंड लीव इट लाइक दैट एंड वॉक अराउंड विद इट एंड प्ले इट जस्ट टू बी ही वाज क्वाइट अटैच्ड टू दैट वीणा एंड वाज प्लेइंग इट ऑल द टाइम।
आई सी And talking of compositions, which are the oldest composers that you have come across in your learning?
You know, there is Nayak Bakshu hai, Nayak Charju ka hai, shayad Tansen ka, usse zyada nahi hai.
Can you give us illustrations? Just share the compositional structure and the styles of those times. Can you give us one example?
I mean,
yeah, but you in this section, if you can give it in this section that we are having, even if you've sung before, but for the sake of the from an academic perspective, you can give illustrations of compositions.
So one different people. Uh-huh. ज्ञान मद मते जैन निसरीन तीन को कबहुल हो तको कारी मारी मन कारी ज्ञान पंचम हरिदास जी का ये भैरव में है झपताल में। हमारे यहाँ मोस्टली आई थिंक झपताल के कॉम्पोजिशंस बहुत हुए हैं।
अच्छा, सुनाओ
झपताल के बहुत हुआ है।
थोड़ा ऊपर हो गया, थोड़ा सुर आई थिंक ज्यादा ऊंचा हो रहा है ना ये।
ज्ञान मद मते जैन निसरीन तीन को कबहु मन का फिर आगे कुछ है हरी संचर हरी दास डागुर को सुमिर कर तरह से है, मतलब ये हरिदास जी का एक है पद हमारे पास बहुत पुराना है। फिर वो नायक बक्षु के वगैरह है, फिर मोस्टली हमारे यहाँ मुझे मैंने देखा कि झपताल इन हमारे यहाँ, मतलब आई एम जस्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट माय फादर माय ग्रैंडफादर जहीरुद्दीन खान साहब, झपताल का ज्यादा चलन है बहुत, जैसे वो मेघ का है प्रबल दल सार भूम जल भूमि पर घूमड घन घोर जल ये पिताजी करते थे और ग्रैंडफादर है प्रबल दल बरसत मूसल धार होता प्रहर चार कृष्ण गी पशु पंची जीव जंतु अधिक सुख पायो है प्रबल दल जय जग तान से वो भी मोस्टली अस्थाई अंतरा कभी कभार तबुक भी होता था।
मियां तानसेन का काफी गाया गया चीजें सबके पास ही थी, सब घराने में थी सबके पास।
हाँ सब, हाँ क्योंकि वो आई थिंक तानसेन वाज फ्रॉम खंडारवाड़ी बट उनके कंपोजिशन सब दूर गाए गए थे।
हाँ सब गाए गए,
थोड़े थोड़े बदल के उनको गाए गए थे। यूजुअली प्रथा यही थी कि अगर जैसे वेस्टर्न क्लासिकल में पहले थी कि आप बाख पढ़िए बेथोवन पढ़िए उसको बजाइए एंड देन यू हैव टू कंपोज योर ओन। सो वन थिंग इन आवर हाउस वाज वेरी क्लियर कि ये क्योंकि ये जो रहमत खान साहब ने ये जिनका तानपुरा है जयपुर में रियाजुद्दीन खान साहब, तो उन्होंने कुछ बाबा बहराम खान साहब के कुछ कंपोजिशन उन्होंने कुछ आड़े टेढ़े करके गाए अपने हिसाब से, तो उन्होंने कहा कि इतना ही शौक है तो अपने बना ला, तो उन्होंने अपने 150-200 उन्होंने कॉम्पिटिशन बना लिए अलग से। तो वो एक हर आदमी को पहले एक सिखाते थे कि ये कॉम्पिटिशन ऐसे है और इसमें राग का ऐसे ऐसे चलन है, ये है, अब तुम अपने बनाओ।
रियाजुद्दीन साहब का कुछ याद आ रहा है, कुछ उनकी कुछ याद है कैसे चल
इनका
रियाजुद्दीन खान साहब का?
नहीं उनका मुझे कुछ नहीं याद आ रहा है।
अच्छा, और
मुझे
अपना आई डोंट नो बिकॉज माय आई वाज लुकिंग फॉर वन ऑफ द कंपोजिशंस माय ग्रैंडफादर डायरी हैड इज बंसीधर पिनाकधर गंगाधर तानसेन का यह है श्री राग का ध्रुपद। You know, my grandfather passed away in 86, so I only learned the Gaudi Bhairavang. Andher Gharbaso Harijan Pyare Sadgur Tumhe Re Kaj Savare. Ek cheez 85 mein, he taught it in October, he died the next year. Then my grand uncles picked me up. So the diaries I was given by my aunts, it had one particular Dhrupad, but I had no way to dig out because the notations were only the markers, you know, for his own recall. There were some Sama, but you cannot make a composition out. Harinarayan Mukhopadhyay wrote a book in 1929 called Dhrupad Surlipi that had that composition. That, so I said, oh, thank God, at least I got a structure of that. के तीन ताल का ध्रुपद है। सो तानसेन, व्हाट डू यू थिंक अबाउट हिज कंपोजिशनल स्ट्रक्चर? कभी देखा है कि व्हाट डू यू थिंक इज यूनिक?
मैंने ज्यादा मैंने इतना कंपोजिशनल स्ट्रक्चर पे मैं अभ्यास नहीं किया है, बट आई लाइक मोर ऑफ बख्शो'स वर्क और हरिदास गागुर्स वर्क इन दैट मैनर।
आई सी।
क्योंकि एक तो बहुत सात्विक है, एक बहुत it's a very erotic kind of ring, Bakshu ka jo hai.
Achha.
But usme kya hai ki aadhe, it's like half sentences he's using, no? And then those half sentences can be made into full sentences, and then you can break the. There is no sense of the whole.
I see.
But the whole is there.
Can you like share something? Kuch yaad aa raha hai kya? Like Bakshu ka.
Wohi na kar pakkar te ya gale hi laga ab tak kuch ki yankiya tar ki. Yehi chhod diya. Matlab aapka imagination aur kahan tak jayega? उसको आप और क्या कर सकते हो और उसका कैसे की कर सकते हो?
सुनाओ कैसे चलता है।
It doesn't say that Krishna is behind the bush. That's how I can smell the. I went to smell the flowers and I could smell the perfume because Krishna is hiding it. Then karapakarate piya gale hi lagavat kochi ki angiya tarki. There's just two different parts suddenly, and then they can be joined together and then super vistara ho sakta hai. So there is like a kind of abstractness in there that you can pull out of it. Fir wo abstractness aapke raagdari mein bhi baithta hai. Raag. हल्का सा कीर्तन करके षडज को आप फिर इसका एक वर्णन होने लगता है मीटर और इसे ताल और लय अलग अलग चल रहे हैं उसमें तो आई लाइक दोस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स बट आई हैव नेवर लुक इन टू मच इनटू आई हैव अ डायरी ऑफ स्टफ एंड बट आई डोंट लुक टू मच इनटू द कंपोजिशन मैं मोस्टली अभी आलाप के अंदर ज्यादा खोजने लगा हूँ एंड माय फादर से कहा अगर तुमको आलाप समझ में आया तो ये कॉम्पोजिशन भी तुमको समझ में आएगी कि इसके साथ क्या करना है क्योंकि उसकी कटिंग और वो रखना है तो जैसे एक दो लाइन अभी मैंने देखी थी इंद्र की अभी देख रहा हूँ गोडमला का, देख रहा हूँ इसमें शुद्ध गंधार इस्तेमाल नहीं हो रहा है.
अच्छा,
तो कैसे हो रहा है वो गोडमला? बहुत राग ऐसे हैं हमारे यहाँ जिनमें वो नॉर्मल स्वर नहीं लगते, जैसे सूरदासी मल्हार में कोमल गंधार लगता है जो यूजुअली लोग नहीं लगाते, जैसे सुनंदा जी के घराने में कोमल गंधार नहीं लगाते सूरदासी में. शुद्ध निषाद का ज़्यादा प्रयोग होता है हमारे यहाँ, कम प्रयोग होता है. तो ये उसमें सूरदासी में ऐसे सा के द्वार सा के द्वार ऐसे नूर को तू रस ऐसे.
बट पुराने आई मीन जितना what I've seen is that the older you go, there were more than one form of the same raga. It was not considered necessary to use all the notes of the same raga.
Also the swaroop.
Exactly.
कभी किसी बंधन पूरा राग था, कभी धैवत पे था, कभी उस पे था, दूसरा composition बिल्कुल और किसी इस पे था.
Yeah. Talking of Malhar, I mean, Shuddh Malhar, the oldest is Sare Mava Dhasa. Shuddh Malhar, just as some kuch hai. Do you remember? Kuch aaya? Kuch usme kabhi gaya gaya? Aapko jitne yaad hai.
Padha hai, lekin abhi maine usko dekha nahi. I've not looked into it. For example,
hamare yahan gaya jaate Guru Arjan's composition from late 16th century.
Acha.
ये चलन है इसका आगे. संचारी अभोग भी चलता है इसका. गुरु अर्जुन का कंपोजिशन हे गोविंद हे गोपाल हे दयाल लाल अस्थाई है. प्राण अनाथ अनाथ सखे धीर दर दर निवार
हे सम्रथ अगम पूरन मोहि मयाधार अंधकूप महाभयान नानक पार उतार. So for example is that, and you see the kind of structures. Then the Shuddh Madhar takes the Tivra Gandhar without the Nikhad, any Nikhad, and the structure. Then came the Malhar with the Tivra Nikhad as well. Then both the Nikhads, mm-hmm. but with the Tivra Gandhar. Then the Kafi Male, Mia Malhar, which is then called, is the advent, mm-hmm. whether Tansen made it famous or he created, it is said that he was created, but it was the Kafi Male version of that. Hmm. So that's the whole advent of that. I think what you mentioned about the Sur Dasi Malhar is again what Sunanda has been studying, what you've been studying, what I've been studying, and others mm-hmm. also we've seen, whether there are certain Gandhars being used or missing, or Tivra Gandhar being used. I've just finished, I'm almost done with the book with about 333 compositions, 327 to be precise. Six others I've given within the foreword in 80 ragas, Sangraha, which I've done over 40 years of learning. Usme I wrote about Barwa, for example, and with Harbhajan Singh Paisa from the Namdhari Darbar, he remembered a Barwa with, in fact, I called Pandit Yashpal and Pandit Somdat Battu as well to discuss about that, because I thought, whoa. This the one that I have, it's got both the Gandhars, and then I called Harbhajan Bhai Sahib. He said, well, I know which has only got one Gandhar, not the other, which is the Tivra Gandhar only. That was, I think it is all it all makes it much more richer. We see how much the elders have seen, you know. It is not a limiting factor, it is a
ये ऐसा कुछ इस पर फिक्स नहीं, क्योंकि मैंने मियाँ के मल्हार विदाउट गंधार सुनी है.
अच्छा.
एक निषाद की मियाँ के मल्हार सुनी है, मतलब बहुत ही गजब है. आप एक निषाद की मियाँ के मल्हार सुनेंगे तो उस्ताद ने गाई थी अभी तक मेरे खोपड़ी में, मतलब बैठी नहीं है, और मुझे लगता है उसके बाद लगता है कि दोनों निषाद वाले सब गड़बड़ है. तो ये इतना कन्विंसिंग भी ये लोग करते हैं ना, तो यू फील लाइक अच्छा ये क्या है, ये क्या हो रहा
है.
अब
yeah, then there is a Malhar of the Bhairav Mela. Imagine Malhar of the Bhairav Mela. I would keep quiet, but then when I was in conversation with Professor S.R. Janakiraman and Professor N. Ramanathan in Chennai, Professor Janakiraman said, oh, there is one Malhar which is in the Bhairav Mela. I said, how is it possible? He says, what do you mean? And also with the Bhairavi, with the Dhanasri of the Bhairavi Mela, the two important ragas we discussed. He says, Tyagaraja has sung one, only one composition in Malhar of the Bhairav Mela. I said, ruk jaiye, ye dekhiye ki main suna raha hu, aap dekhega ki waisa hai ki nahi. And I sang for Guru Arjan's Pancham Sawari, 15 beats. Let Sri Ram Nama Mele Sad Sangar Haridur Haridhan Ban Jau Haridhan Sancho Jese Lao Gat Hai Nai Cho जेस लागत है नहीं चोर हर जन. मेरा गला बैठा हुआ है जिसकी मैं वो हैरान हो गया, कह रहे. एंड ही सैंग त्यागराजस मल्हार इन भैरव मेले, ही वाज आइडेंटिकल. आई सेड दिस इज क्रेजी, दिस इज गेटिंग टू क्रीपी. मैं गा रहा हूँ फ्रॉम द स्वर्ण मंदिर, एग्जैक्टली. आई मीन स्वर्ण मंदिर की चीज गा रहा हूँ, गुरु रामदास, एंड देन इन चेन्नई त्यागराजस कंपोजिशन. It's extraordinary.
Mm-hmm.
It's extraordinary. And वो याद आ रही है मल्हार वाली, जो मल्हार जो अकेली निखाद वाली मल्हार है?
नहीं, वो उनने सिर्फ आलाप गा के
बताया. अच्छा, आलाप गा के बताया. अच्छा,
हाँ, वो जो निषाद है वो दोनों निषाद के बीच में खड़ी है.
अच्छा,
वो बहुत कठिन है वो. हाँ, वो अब वो निषाद लगना ही मुश्किल है, ऐसे हो जाता है.
अच्छा अच्छा, क्या बात है, क्या बात है. क्या बजाने का कोई मूड कर रहा है क्या?
We will have to cut because my dongle is going to go off any moment.
Dongle so is going to go. Yeah, I know. Yeah.
Yeah.
Dongle is going to go. Would you like to play something at the end before we call it quits, or you want to cut it before without playing?
We'll just cut it because I don't know when it's going to go.
I see.
Because it will go off.
Theek hai, theek hai. So that's very kind of you taking time out.
Not at all. It was nice.
Tum bhi keh do na ke thank you for inviting me. Come
we'll
on.
We'll meet separately.
The nautanki of the dunya is when I say, oh, thank you so much for accepting my invitation. Then you say, oh, thank you so much for inviting me to this. What does it say? This. But we are so naughty, isn't it? We are so informal. But you know, we have not taken each other's nicknames. That's one good thing we have done for the first time publicly. We have behaved.
Yeah,
but thank you so much. It was such a pleasure. I'm glad that we've tried to be in conversation for I don't know what 3 months, and your internet connect was not working initially. Today also it's been very low resolution, about 180 pixels, and right now it's 240 pixels. It's fluctuating. I think it's more depending on your think the Wi-Fi connectivity. There is automatically, it has not gone over 340 or 50 pixels. So, very blurred image. You're such a bad boy. Ye jaan ke, ye saajish hai, dongle kharab hai. Pixel bhi kanjusi karke de rahe ho. But how is the weather now? How's the village in Palaspe? Is all okay? No COVID-19 related issues?
There are a few cases, but they're not very severe.
I see.
Things are okay.
Okay. And I heard from common friends that you hate me behind my back.
Absolutely.
Why is that? You want to tell me the reason?
Because hatred is the first sign of love.
Hi. I didn't expect that. I see. So it's only on the first sign only, ya ishq ushk ho gaya, ishq mushk ho gaya hai.
Ho jata hai na wo.
Well, let's hope this thing gets off. Then we should maybe. I was in fact planning something for the concluding ceremony of Guru Nanak's. This series, Yaranath Virtual Betak series, is dedicated to the 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev. And I was planning a concluding event, but I don't know how it is. It's already now September, and end of November is the 550th concluding. But if I get a chance, I hope that we'll all be able to get together like we got together in Patna. It was fun for 6 days.
We were like, fun. Yes, really nice.
And I hope. Otherwise, in any case, we'll have, I think when we do, when we are all able to get back. Funding is now a big issue. I mean, I spoke with the Punjab government, with the CM office. I said, "Kuch karo artists ke liye, we should do something." They said this, the income of the state has gone is like 79% negative. They don't have money even to repair the roads. So it's like a crazy situation right now.
It's really bad.
Yeah, it's very bad. Thank you so much, Ustad Mohi Bahauddin Khan. I was about to. I was about to. I was about to. Look at that. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for taking time out, and my love to everybody. I'll hope to see you and talk to you soon.
Yeah,
it was such a pleasure. Acha, oh, jaane se pehle, ek main baat bhool hi gaya. That's dangerous. You had shared some of the images of the Veena that you have created.
So there is this boy.
Right. And
There's this.
So I'm now showing it on the screen. Okay, it is opening up, and iske baare mein kuch bata do ki ye kya hai.
So ek ladka hai, Kunal Joshi karke, he's a sculptor from Ratnagiri.
I see.
Adilabad mein jo गुरुजी थे एक, उनके पास वो सीखता था, उनको उनको देसी विद्याएं पता थी. तो 8 साल वो उनके पास सीखा, एंड देन आई कॉल्ड हिम टू डू अ जॉब अबाउट जस्ट टू मेक अ पीकॉक एंड अ ड्रैगन. बट ही स्टेड ओवर एंड देन आई गॉट हिम, यू नो, आई काइंड ऑफ गॉट हिम इंटरेस्टेड इन टू व्हाट द वीणा इज एंड हाउ इट इज मेड, एंड ही इज मेड दिस वीणा नाउ. द तुम्बास आर मेड बाय नईम सतारमेकर, बट एंटायर carving, everything is done by hand, single-handedly, from the frets to the everything. Uh-huh. And this is his first veena. So in the future, now we have a younger veena maker.
I see.
But he will take, he's taken about 1.5 years to make this. Hmm. And now he says he wants to make the next one in 3 years, because he says it requires a lot of time and patience and thinking. And he's just 22, 23 years old.
Really?
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Very. Yeah, it's really fantastic. In fact, I was asking him to come to you to learn some techniques of polish and everything.
Yeah, yeah.
It'll be nice. I will send him to you once.
Yeah, yeah. We'll work on that.
He's quite a brilliant fellow, actually. Uh-huh. And he was a sculptor, but he went home today. Yesterday, in fact, he caught the train and he went home. And he told his parents, this is what I want to do in my
really?
Life. I want to make veenas.
I see. तो उसको सिखाते हैं ना उसको, आई विल टीच हिम हाउ टू मेक द रबाब एंड द पुराना वाला जो जितने इंस्ट्रूमेंट किए हैं मैन, यू नो, आई वुड बी माय प्लेजर. दिस इज ब्रिलियंट.
या
एंड ही स्टेड विद यू फॉर नियरली
16 मंथ्स. 16 मंथ्स ही वाज हियर विद मी. या 16 17 मंथ्स ही हैज बीन देयर विद मी. एंड ही गॉट अ फेलोशिप स्कॉलरशिप फ्रॉम टाटास to do this project. So next year the scholarship is going to get over and he's going to make one more by the time.
I see.
And we're going to document that this time, how to make,
uh-huh.
how he's making it and all that.
I see. This is fantastic.
Yeah, it's sounding good also. It's really sounding good. Hmm. And I'm happy. I'm happy with the outcome of this because I wanted a good quality veena, not just the decoration, but you know, and decoration had become very difficult nowadays because the craftsmen don't want to work.
Yeah.
It takes too much time.
Mm.
So he's been spending time and very carefully doing stuff.
Well, it's a big problem. I mean, with the idea of luthiery, it's not the quality, the work that is there, sensitivity. People are now making instruments just by looking from photos or paintings and some sculptures. They don't understand the actual art of luthiery, the instrument making, that there's a whole philosophy, the ergonomics of it that is involved. It was fun to watch you play that when you played the rabab that I had handcrafted when you were in Delhi last.
Well, that's such a beautiful instrument. Yeah.
It'll be, I think we need to work on that as well. The next pair that I'm going to make and make it available. We should do a project together on that. Kuch karenge uske saath. Yeah. That's wonderful. Everybody saw the images. Maine dikha di saath mein. As you were talking, I had you in the picture-in-picture and the images of the ones that you have done. That's compliments to the young fellow. It'll be my pleasure to meet with him. Thank you again. Lots of love.
Okay,
I mean, lots
you.
Of hatred, by the way. Yeah. The first sign of love. No. Yeah. आपसे मुलाकात हुई बहुत अफसोस हुआ. It was.
Yeah.
बहुत दुख हुआ आपसे बात की मैंने. आपने मेरा न्योता कबूल किया. आप बहुत खराब हैं. आपने बहुत खराब बात की. आपका फर्ज बनता था कि मैं आपको फोन करता रहता. आई शुड हैव जस्ट कंटिन्यू टू कॉल यू एंड यू शुड हैव इग्नोर्ड. दैट्स हाउ स्टार्स बिहेव. यू नो, यू आर नॉट सपोज्ड टू पिक अप माय फोन. दैट यू गेट टू.
आई डोंट वांट टू बिकम द स्टार. आई वांट टू बिकम द मून.
सो ओके, आई विल टेक द ओनली थिंग रिजर्वड इन द स्काईज व्हिच इज सन. आई विल बी द सन देन, जस्ट बिकॉज यू चोज द मून. ठीक है. All right. It was lovely. Thank you so much for sharing. And there's so much to talk. We'll, of course, this is not the last. Zindagi rahi to mulaqat hogi. We'll continue our conversation. And I want to touch on the rag malas, etc. also. You played the Megh and the Bhairo. And the, I think we Shri also you touched upon. I think we'll also continue the conversation on the rag forms of how they are.
I love the way the importance of the Shruti, how even Tanpura's courage would be changed for the Komal Gandhar Swara and for the Tivra Gandhar and so on and so forth. So I think those are sensibilities that are not there anymore, especially with the electronic stuff everywhere. It is, but of course, technology and which is there. But I think it's very important to remember the subtleties and the vision with which rag and the nad have been attended to, and the sensitivity as well that the grand elders of our civilization had.
Yeah.
And we are remembering them. We are honoring them. And I thank everyone, those who joined us today. And Shabana says, very informative. Thanks, both of you. So she hates me too, by the way. Yeah. But she loves you. You know, she does the sister thing. Is my bhaiya, you know. Very biased. Good night.
Good night.
So friends, that was my conversation with Saad Mohi Bahauddin and of the Dagubani. And I hope you enjoyed the conversation. And tomorrow is another Baithak. And I'm looking forward to that too, with the theatre director and Padma Shri awardee, Dr. Neelam Mansingh. I'll be in conversation with her tomorrow. Kindly take note of this. And we'll be starting at 5 p.m. tomorrow. That will be the 130th Yaranad Virtual Baithak Series Mela. Our families have known each other for, I don't know, generations. Her dad, Dr. Mansingh Nirankari, was quite a fantastic, just a fascinating elder. One of the greatest men as in people I've ever met. One of the greatest souls, if I may rephrase. And I hope that you'll take time out and join us at 5 p.m. tomorrow evening, Saturday, September 5th. It's my nephew Amiteshwar's birthday tomorrow. So I'll be virtually traveling to Chandigarh. Dosto, kal meri mulaqat hoegi natak de khetar de vaddi hasti, Padma Shri awardee, Dr. Neelam Mansingh Chaudhary. 5 baje shami hoega Chandigarh to mere naal judange. Inna diyan kuch films vi hagiyan ne, jehde theater jehda natak jehda film kita hoya, oh vi unhone saanjhiyan kitiyan ne, assi dikhavange. So badi meharbani hoegi tusi kal da samaan note kar lena. Aap ji de parivar buzurg aur mere buzurg bahut unhan da aapas saanjh rahi hai. Mainu aas hai tusi kal tusi samaan kadoge. ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਅਹਿਮ ਇਹ ਮੁਲਾਕਾਤ ਹੋਏਗੀ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਦੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈਗੀ ਹੈ ਇੱਕ ਨਵੀਂ ਲੜੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਨਾਟਕ ਦੇ ਵੱਡੇ ਹੈਗੇ ਨੇ ਵੱਡੇ ਵਡੇਰੇ ਵਤਨ ਦੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਵਾਰਤਾਵਾਂ ਦੀ ਲੜੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਹੈ ਐਕਟਰਸ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਦੇਖੀ ਹੈ ਰਮਨਜੀਤ ਕੌਰ ਕੁਲਜੀਤ ਸਿੰਘ ਔਰ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲ ਅਪੀਅਰੈਂਸ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸੀ ਵੰਸ਼ ਪ੍ਰਭਾਤ ਔਰ ਤਰਨਜੀਤ ਕੌਰ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਵੀ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਸੀਗਾ ਹੋਰ ਕਈ ਆਣੇ ਨੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਵੱਡੇ ਪ੍ਰੋਟੈਗਨਿਸਟ ਹੈਗੇ ਨੇ ਥੀਏਟਰ ਦੇ ਐਕਟਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਪਰ ਥੀਏਟਰ ਡਾਇਰੈਕਟਰਸ ਦੀ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਲੜੀ ਹੈ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਬੜਾ ਮਾਣ ਹੈ ਇਸ ਗੱਲ ਦਾ ਕਿ ਡਾਕਟਰ ਨੀਲਮ ਮਾਨ ਸਿੰਘ ਚੌਧਰੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਇਹ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਵਾਰਤਾ ਹੈ ਦਿਸ ਕਨਵਰਸੇਸ਼ਨ ਔਨ ਥੀਏਟਰ ਫਰੋਮ ਏ ਡਾਇਰੈਕਟਰਸ ਪਰਸਪੈਕਟਿਵ ਏ ਥਿੰਕਰ ਐਂਡ ਏ ਫਿਲੋਸਫਰਸ ਪਰਸਪੈਕਟਿਵ ਉਹ ਡਾਕਟਰ ਨੀਲਮ ਮਾਨ ਸਿੰਘ ਚੌਧਰੀ ਤੋਂ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਹੋਏਗੀ ਸੋ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਜ਼ਰੂਰ ਸਮਾਂ ਕੱਢਣਾ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਆਸ ਹੈ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਅੱਜ ਦੀ ਮੁਲਾਕਾਤ ਅੱਛੀ ਲੱਗੀ ਹੋਏਗੀ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਸਾਰੇ ਜੁੜੇ ਹੋ yes, Tamanjeet, I'm looking forward to attending tomorrow's conversation too along with you all. And thank you all. Thank you all so very much for joining today. And I hope that you keep well, that you behave, and that you laugh some, and you are naughty some, and keep well, and keep others well. Keep people at a safe distance. Many people, even in the US, I'm alarmed. Over 6 million people are now. I have not yet done for many, many weeks any COVID-19 monologue. I will plan to start those also at least once or twice a week. It is very alarming. In Europe, the infection is again growing and people are talking about herd mentality. But the scientists are telling it'll come at an expense. Over 2 million people could die before herd mentality comes in. And there's no guarantee either. It's just a hunch that just because you get infected, you will have immunity. It is not that. It is the loss of life that will be incurred. And with no end in sight, no, you know, we don't know how deep the well would be. The best is the greatest tool that we have against this virus is to keep distance, to keep clean, not to merge. There's a story, there's a doctor, Canada's top scientist has also said that even any intimate connect or relationship that you have, do not have with strangers, any exchange of bodily fluids, whether it's saliva or anything. It's dangerous. It's dangerous. So it's time is to keep distance, and I hope that you're keeping well in that way. Not just be safe, but keep others, take care of others as well. And I'll see you tomorrow at 5 p.m. Unless technology commands that I'm a few minutes later, but I look forward to having my conversation with Padma Shri awardee, Dr. Neelam Man Singh Chaudhary. Khuda hafiz, namaskar, Wahguru Ji ka khalsa, Wahguru Ji ki fateh, very good night to everyone, Satkartar.